get the ball to him. Of course, that was Bo Allen, the quarterback last year for Lexcanth, and this year you got Jack Goman.
Yeah, Goman's pretty good. Bo Allen was exceptional, though. He was really special.
We'll step out on the prepspin.com Mingy Beef Jerky Game of the Week. We'll come back with the starting lineups. It's Covington Catholic and Lexington Catholic here at the Lexcanth. We'll come back after this timeout.
Same apples, same phone, same coffee, same items, different prices. So why would you pay more for the same thing? Lexington Diagnostic Center and Open MRI can save you 30 to 60% compared to the costs of local hospitals. We have a state-of-the-art facility in the Lexington area. We believe that every patient deserves the best in affordable, quality care. Avoid surprise billing. Come to Lexington Diagnostic Center, imaging focused on you.
By the numbers, Whitaker Bank loves the Kentucky communities we serve.
Whitaker Bank supports 496 Kentucky schools.
Over 282,000 students benefit from Whitaker Bank's Kentucky education initiatives.
Whitaker Bank has contributed almost $441,000 to education programs for the advancement of Kentucky's youth.
We share your passion, Kentucky.
Love the bank that loves you back.
Whitaker Bank is uniquely Kentucky.
Same shoes, same mixer, same computer, same items, different prices. So why would you pay more for the same thing? Lexington Diagnostic Center and Open MRI can save you 30 to 60% compared to the costs of local hospitals. We have a state-of-the-art facility in the Lexington area. We believe that every patient deserves the best in affordable, quality care. Avoid surprise billing. Come to Lexington Diagnostic Center, imaging focused on you.
Folks, this is Gary Ball, and you hear my catchphrase, soup and a sandwich. When I want the best potato soup and prime rib sandwich, I head over to Rafferty's Restaurants after my games. Check out Rafferty's 9 great locations throughout Kentucky, and all you teens, you can eat at Rafferty's before those big ball games. The open prime rib sandwich is what legends are made of. Ask Joe B. Hall, the legend himself, it's his favorite. Rafferty's a big supporter of high school sports throughout Kentucky. Rafferty's, where the special is you.
Welcome back here to Lexington Catholic. Gary Ball with Coach Mike Meehan and Jack Haynes producing tonight. He's the Prince of Stream tonight. The King of Stream is over at the KHSAA doing his thing with volleyball. Ty Schott is with us as well. It's Lexington Catholic and Covington Catholic. Let's give the starting lineups for you tonight that we were given by the coaches of both football teams. And I'll tell you about Eddie Evanston. I talked to him or got an email from him earlier. So, and you got some UFOs coming up there. Outstanding, Coach.
Very good. Excellent UFOs.
Covington Catholic, their starting lineup will look like this. Peyton Dietz is the center, 6'2", 260-pound junior. Tommy Schramm is a 5'10", 220 sophomore right guard. Ben Dickhouse is 6'4", 230, and a senior. But it's not on the offensive line, although he's good there, Coach. It's on the defensive side. We're going to call his name a lot tonight.
That's what you were telling me. I can't wait to see him.
And Ken Januszewski, a 6'1", 210-pound senior left guard. Sam Eplin, 6'1", 210 junior, is the left tackle. Trevor Wilson's the 6'3", 190 junior wide out, along with Ryan Schneider, a 5'10", 165-pound senior. And the backfield will look like this. Caleb Jacob is your 6'4 quarterback. He's a 215-pound senior. And 4 years of varsity football at Covington Catholic, the young man is going for his third state championship this year at Covington Catholic. That's pretty remarkable. The only year he didn't win it was the year that they were runner-up his sophomore year to South Warren.
Who really upset them. And very good team, though.
Owen Nally is the leading running back, and the guy that will be featured as a back tonight, a 5'11 senior. 79 carries, 343 yards, 7 touchdowns in just 7 football games. Garrett Binky is the other wideout, 6'1", 190 sophomore, and Ethan Reardon is the deep threat, 6'5", 190-pound senior. He's a college prospect, 6'5". He's got 28 catches, 467 yards, 4 touchdowns coming into this game tonight.
Yeah, be interesting to see how that all plays out.
And we'll hear that offense first tonight because Lex Cath will be kicking to Covington Catholic tonight via the deferment, what they won the toss, deferred to the second half.
Yes, yes, they did.
So we'll take a look at the Lexington Catholic defense. And, man, it's when we look at their offense, that offensive line is totally revamped almost.
Yeah, that's I don't know what's going on.
Well, these either injuries or just guys stepping up or whatever. So the defense will look like this. Elliot Movero, a 6'2", 245-pound junior, will be the nose tackle. Quentin Duffy, a 6'1", 290 junior, is the right defensive tackle. Luke Wasik, 5'10", 200-pound senior, is the defensive end on the left side. Then you look at the linebackers. Jackson Klein, a 6'1", 170-pound senior. Kimbo Mufata, 6'3", 200-pound senior. Jack Powell. I think Gavin Klein is going to play a lot there tonight as well. And I believe on the depth chart I got yesterday, John Martin Sims is not on that depth chart as a starter. So Jackson Corbett should get the start at the night linebacker tonight for Lexington Catholic. Teddy Bullock is a corner, 5'11", 170 senior. Pierce Hall is the outstanding Mike linebacker, one of the leading tacklers on the team. He's been steady Eddie this year, Coach.
Absolutely, and he can bring the wood, too. He's an excellent tackler.
And Jack Malley, a junior, will play at strong safety. And the other corners, Johnny Woodall, 6-foot senior. And that should be the defense. We'll, of course, check them for you tonight as we get through the course of this game. And, Coach Meehan, what do you expect here in this game? Covington Catholic, Lex Cath battling here tonight at Lexington Catholic. What do you expect here tonight?
Well, I'm interested in seeing if Lexington Catholic can solve that defense of Covington Catholic. We're going to look real closely at both. I am at both interior linemen, offense and defense,
right,
and see who's winning the battle down there. I'm a little concerned. I think Lexington or Covington Catholic's defense is just a little too strong for the teams that we've seen this year, with the exception of maybe Douglas.
Yeah, well, you know, they've Lexington Catholic has, of course, played Boyle County. They played Lexington Christian, who had a really good defense over at Lex. We saw that defense last week, totally shut down a defending state champion in Pikeville. So, yeah. Lexington Catholic, I think the key tonight is Goman's got to run the ball well. He's got to throw the ball well. As Goman goes, I think tonight Lexington Catholic will go.
That's a good point, Gary, and especially running the football, because when he gets the ball in his hands, he can do some damage running the ball.
Yeah, Goman has some impressive stats. When you look at his stats, he does have 12 touchdown passes, so the young man could throw the ball, has 4 rushing touchdowns. So we'll see tonight. You got some good receivers for both football teams. I'm interested to see this Ethan Reardon young man. We saw him last year up at the Covington Catholic. And boy, nice facility up there at the Covington Catholic, wasn't it?
Beautiful. It's a really nice facility right across from Notre Dame Academy up there. Just a beautiful area. This is beautiful, too. And, Gary, what a beautiful night.
It is.
Oh, my gosh, what a great night for football.
Gorgeous night, and it's going to be a good one here. Just sit back, and it's going to kick off at 7 o'clock. How about that, Coach?
Yeah, 7 o'clock, a little bit earlier than usual. That's good.
7 o'clock kickoff here. Here come the Knights and the Colonels from Covington Catholic, but here come the Lexington Catholic Knights under Nigel Smith. And I tell you what, the coordinators here are outstanding. Kevin Brugman does a great job as the defensive coordinator, and he's acting as the athletic director right now. Shout out tonight to Ann Brugman and all the Brugmans. I think they're watching over there tonight.
That's awesome. Yeah, he does a great job. We've watched his defense the last couple of years, and he gets better. Those kids, one thing, let me tell you something. Here's the thing about Lexington Catholic. They develop athletes. They get some kids come in here that are good athletes, and they make them really, really good athletes. So that's one of the most important things that a coach can do is develop the kids that they get.
You're exactly right, and it'll be DeGraff kicking off for Lex Cath, and Cove Cath has been putting back different guys this year. They've had about 5 different guys they put back to receive the kicks, according to their coach. So, you know, we'll just have to see who drops back there and returns the kick for Covington Catholic. They're 7-0. They went undefeated last year, won the 5A state title, won the championship game 14-7 over that very good Douglas team. And we thought that game could go either way, Coach. We thought Douglas had the firepower, and we thought that they would give Lex Cath, Covington Catholic a really good game, and they did.
Well, a lot of people were saying, oh, it's going to be a high score, over under, really high, and yet it was a defensive game. Here they come.
Here comes Lexington Catholic and Covington Catholic. You got to get your Catholic straight tonight, don't you?
Yeah, that's one way of putting it.
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll do our best. It's the Knights and the Colonels.
That's right. Knights and Colonels.
And the Colonels.
So we'll see who drops back deep there for Covcath. Dropping back deep is a freshman, Cameron Geisler, number 4. And he's back there. He's to the near side.
34.
And to the far side. And that's number 34, Coach.
Sanfoss.
Yeah, Robbie Sanfoss. How'd they get a Sanfoss over Covcath? I thought all the Sanfosses went to Newport Catholic.
You know, probably.
You get a few of them. I'd say Eddie Evanston's connection. Got that Sanfoss.
Maybe it was an Uber.
Yeah.
That's how they got him over there.
Sanfoss to the far and Geisler to the near. Waiting for this DeGraff kick and ready to get this game underway here at Lexington Catholic. The kick is off, and it's going to be deep, and it's going to be at the 5-yard line. And coming out to the 10, 20, 25, to the 30, and finally knocked out of bounds at the 38-yard line on the return there, and that was Sanfoss. So Sanfoss out of bounds, and coach is, I think, going to take care of the lights. Coach, I can't get my light to come on now.
It's just really have a lot of reflections on the window.
Yeah,
here.
Yeah. So, Covcath will come out.
All right, let's get this game
underway. We set the offense for you, and we set the defenses for you. Reardon was split out to the near side. Wilson out there. Twins out to the top. And Nally is to the left of Caleb Jacob. Jacob now shift to the right side. Jacob fakes into the line, throws it deep down the right side, and it's going to be intercepted. Picked off, and back there in coverage, coming up with it, Coach. That was number 20. That's Teddy Bullock. Bullock came up with the interception. Good job by Ted Bullock. Boy, he got back in coverage, and that was a great pick there. So interception, so Lexington Catholic, they will start Harrison Romero at center. They got Patrick Davis at right guard, Quentin Duffy at right tackle, Elliot Movero at left guard, and Jake Nash. You got Jack Goman coming out at quarterback. Darren Eldridge is the running back. Jackson Corbett, Dylan Bracken, Blake Buesen, and Jack Mundy are the receivers. And We got twins out to the near side, twins to the far side. Goman gives inside of what defense there as he's smothered in the backfield.
Yeah, that was a really, really nice
and
job.
That was Blair, I believe, sure, the backup running back. Yeah, Chase Blair. That wasn't even Eldridge. Chase Blair, the backup running back. Who got him there, Coach?
Max Lowry got him. Just really.
Yeah, he's the nose tackle. We'll check the Covcath defense when we get an opportunity. The first play of scrimmage was intercepted by Bullock of Lexington Catholic, and then the first play they had a backup running back in there, and Blair was smothered, lost about 3 yards. Second down and 13. Goman sends Blair out in motion. Back to pass. Goman, he's got some running room, and he throws it, and it is through the hands of the receiver, incomplete.
Yeah, that was a tough throw, a hard throw to catch. Let me put it that way. He was running forward, put a lot of zip on the ball, and threw it right at the receiver. Instead of leading him a little bit, you know, These kids like to run under a ball to catch it.
Yeah.
Put a little air
that
on
was
it.
Tanner Pedroshi, number 16.
But that showed a weakness. That center of that field was open.
Third and 13. Just underway here, 11 minutes to go in this first quarter. Lexington Catholic intercepted the first pass from Caleb Jacob. Rolling to the right is Goman. Goman still rolling, firing back toward the middle. Is it caught? Up at the 35, and yes, it's
no.
What do they rule?
They rule to hit
the ground. The officials are talking about it. One thinks he caught it, and the other one doesn't think he caught it, and they're going to rule it right there at the 35, and they're going to say it's a catch by Jackson Corbett, Coach.
Well, you know what? We can't really see the replay from where I'm sitting, but did he catch it?
Yeah, he caught it on the replay.
Our producer said he caught it on the replay.
So fourth down and about 3. Lexington Catholic showing no signs of punting it.
They have a quick kick that
I was going to say that, Coach. Yeah. You're exactly right.
They've used it over the years quite a bit too.
And Goman is back there, and he can quick kick it. And He does. Quick kick. Get away. And it goes through the hands of the return man. And he dives back onto that 25-yard line. And that's Ryan Schneider.
Ryan Schneider did a good job on that ball. He muffed it a little bit. But when he ran back, he fell on the ball. When you try to pick those things up and they're rolling away from you,
yep.
Oh, Lord, all you're doing is knocking it toward the other team's end zone. So
we'll see Covington Catholic for the second time offense. We saw for one play, and the quarterback threw it down the right side, and Teddy Bullock picked it off.
Yeah, Lexington Catholic was in a man-to-man defense, and they ran right with them.
Binky splits out to the top. They got triple receivers over there, and Caleb Jacob. From the 25-yard line, looking to the left. Jacob, inside handoff, and stacked up is going to be Collins, Braden Collins, the backup tailback in their finale.
That was a really nice job by Duffy out there. Quentin Duffy did a super job of collapsing.
Pierce Hall was in there as well, Coach.
Well, I know. Duffy collapsed the line of scrimmage, and Hall came up in and cleaned it up.
Yeah.
Just let me come limping off here.
Yeah. That's Pierce Hall. And Jack Mundy comes running in there to replace him. Caleb Jacob intercepted on the motion now by the near side by Snyder around the right side. Breaks a tackle to 31-yard line. And getting over there helping on the play was Malley, Jack Malley.
Yeah, Jack Malley's going to be in on a lot of tackles, Gary. He's really – he attacks the line of scrimmage. They do a really good job of pinning people inside, not letting them get outside on them.
Third and four. Here's a big third down in this game, Coach. First third down for Covcat. They've got to get up to the 36 for a first down. Twins both sides. Motion to the near side by Schneider. Back, and here's a pass. This Schneider, he's got it at the 40. Schneider bulls his way up to the 45-yard line. And he's upended there, and coming up to knock him down was J.D. Woodall.
Yeah, that was a tough one. They put him in motion, Snyder in motion, and he just released quickly in the flat. Very difficult to cover that. If you're playing man-to-man, it's almost impossible to keep up with the receiver.
Yeah, it was a pickup of about 10 yards and a first down up to the 46-yard line for Covcath and their quarterback, Caleb Jacob. He's been offered by Monmouth, Coach.
Yeah, he's an impressive-looking kid for sure.
6'4". Sends a motion man to the far side. Gives to Collins down to the 50, and he's down, bulls his way to the 49-yard line. And tackled right there is a couple of folks getting up there, and that was one of them is Teddy Bullock.
Yeah.
So Braden Collins has come in and been the primary ball carrier. Normally it's Owen Nally.
Well, we don't know why. I mean, you know, there's a lot of reasons there could be problems. But honestly, they're going to have to keep fresh bodies in there.
Exactly. Second down and five. That was a pickup of five, and they're in Lexington Catholic territory, Coach. Covcath, 7-0, ranked number one in the state in 5A, up there with Owensboro and Douglas. Inside handoff and breaking a tackle and down to the 45-yard line. And he broke a tackle, and that was Braden Collins again. He got down to the 45, and he's got the first down.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that was Mufafa that came up there to make that tackle.
Mufata.
Yeah, I think Lexington Catholic, I'm watching their defense and their defensive line. Their job really is to try to collapse that line inside and just jam the holes up inside on running plays.
Garrett Binky goes out to the top. You got to watch Reardon. He's over here to the near side. In motion goes Wilson.
Playing man-to-man on him too, Garrett.
And Caleb Jacob into Collins, hit in the line. There's a flag coming down as they handed the ball off to Braden Collins, and penalty marker comes down. I think that might be holding.
Yeah, the umpire made the call, so.
It's usually holding, isn't it, Coach?
Usually umpire, yep. Yep, holding.
So that'll cost him 10 yards. Eddie Eviston is the outstanding coach for Covington Catholic. He's won several state titles. He won some with Newport Catholic before he came over to Covcath.
Heck of a quarterback himself.
Yes, he was.
Oh, boy.
All-American. Played professional. He played for the Horsemen when I did the radio and got to know Eddie really well. He's just a super, super guy.
They moved it, and then they moved it back. I don't know what what's going on here.
I'm a big Eddie Eviston fan, and, of course, Nigel Smith, the great coach at LexCath, does a great job. So I don't know what they did with the penalty, but it's still second down and about nine.
Yeah.
Wilson, Binky go out to the top, and Ethan Reardon is split out all the way out to the left side. Individual coverage, and Jacob back, dances, and it's going to be caught by Wilson. No, he dropped it. He looked like he caught it from here, but he dropped the football.
Oh, boy.
That'll be third down and about nine.
Yeah, he was really covered well, too. It's pretty cool. I'm watching, again, these offensive and defensive linemen are just going at it. It's amazing. Lexington Catholic is running a cover one, Gary.
Yep.
They're actually man-to-man across the field, but with a free safety. And I'm sure that free safety is there to cover that home run ball that they're known to throw.
This is a big third and almost 10. It's really about 9.5, Coach. Let's see what the Colonels do against the Knights. Just a three-man front there for the Lexington Catholic Knights. Triple receivers to the bottom. Reardon's out there as well. Back to pass, Caleb Jacob. Jacob fires, and it's going to be knocked away. What a play turned in there by Coach, that is a super play by J.D. Woodall.
J.D. Woodall, one of my favorite players. I've watched him for a couple years now. Very aggressive, knows where to – he can read the play, read the offense.
His timing was perfect on that.
We've seen that before, though. He's really good at that. Nice job, Woodall.
Covington Catholic has had the ball twice. They threw an interception the first time they had it, and then Lexington Catholic holds them here, and we got Covcath punting. Granati, I believe, does the punting. And he's back at his own 42-yard line.
Dangerous return man back there.
Waiting long snap. They're trying to draw. Here's the snap. And Granati gets off a high punt. And it will be returned to the 15 and up to the 20-yard line. And that, it might be a late hit there, but they're going to get Woodall the return. And the late hit was made there by number 11, Aiden Jones, but I guess he was still on the sideline,
yeah,
Coach.
He was right on the sideline. They let him get away with that one. That's fine.
So let's see what Goman can do here. He's the first time he had some receivers, that, particularly Pedroche, downfield open, and he threw it a little bit behind him.
Yeah, but also, Gary, he had some running room too.
Exactly. He could have ran about 10 yards on
absolutely.
That play. You're right.
I'm sure they're looking at that, and they're telling them on the sideline, hey, if you see it, take it.
And Jack Goman is a second leading rusher on the football team.
Yeah.
6:43, no score here. Lexington Catholic, Covington Catholic. Motion to the far side by Mundy. They get it over on the bubble screen, and they take it up to the 26-yard line. Jackson Corbett on the catch.
Yeah, there was nowhere to go, really. Honestly, pretty good job of defending that play. Jones in there.
He picked up about four. Second down and six.
Aiden Jones, a 6'3", 185-pound sophomore.
Yeah, I got to set the defense. I think I set the Covcath offense.
That's all right.
I haven't had time to set the defense. It's been such a
– No, they've been going back.
Exactly.
Oh, yeah.
Goman. He sends Blair a little bit further over to the right side. Gives it back inside to him. Blair cuts it up and tries to cut it outside. And he's going to run it to the 35. Nice run. He got the first down. Up to the 30. Let's see where they mark him at, about the 32-yard line. Nice run there by Chase Blair.
Yeah, did a really nice job. Actually beat the edge player. Somebody missed the tackle, and he just turned the corner. It got knocked out of bounds, so that was the only thing that stopped him was the sideline.
So the Knights move the chains, Coach. First down. Blair's to the right. They haven't used Eldridge yet in this ball game. He's the leading rusher on the team. Nice shifts out to the right to join Corbett and Mundy. And you got Buesen along with Klein, I think, out to the far side. Goman, first down and 10. Lexington Catholic. Goman takes a snap, fires it over, and it's caught. Spun around up to the 40. Nice running over there, Coach. And
dancing on the sideline, did a good job.
That was Blake Buesen, I believe.
Yeah. One thing I like about Goman, when he pulls the trigger, he pulls it quickly. I mean, that ball comes out of his hand like a shot.
Same thing in basketball, Coach. He's got a quick release in basketball, too. He'll be one of the leading scorers coming back this year for Lexington Catholic. Of course, we know the leading scorer is Ben Johnson. He led the whole region in scoring, I think, along with the Marquise over at Henry Clay, Marquez. Second down at about a yard for Lexcav. Goman fakes, fires, and Mundy has the catch and the first down. Then he's gang tackled there. There's a host of people coming up to get him. And in particular, Charlie Sora got him, number 26. Trevor Wilson's a defensive end along with Ben Dickhouse. Max Lowry, who made the first defensive play of the game. Sam Francis, the Will linebacker. The Buck linebacker's Aiden Jones. Coach has already talked about him. Sullivan is the linebacker. Adam Holtz. In the corners are Robbie Sanfis, Jacob Daneman. Charlie Sora just made that play along with Ryan Schneider of the safeties. So first down up to the 46-yard line. Goman fakes. Little touch pass out to the right side. Blair, and he's going to be tripped up. And he's on the play there is Ryan Schneider.
Gary, the Cardinals are playing to stop the run. They're jamming the line of scrimmage. They've got everybody up there. They're daring Goman to pass. They're daring him to throw the ball down the field. So it'll be interesting here what the philosophy is. It's almost – it's like a 4-3, but it's really, honestly, more like a – sometimes like a 5-2.
Yeah, we called him Lance Wasick, didn't we, Coach?
Yeah.
I'll tell you, people were worried about that one. Here's a handoff, and that's going to be Corbett, and he's going to get down into Covington Catholic territory.
Yeah, you're not going to let him turn the corner. The Colonels are really good at that. Again, I'm going to repeat it again. They've come to this game to stop the run. I don't know what their philosophy is. They feel like their secondary can cover the receivers, so everybody else is going to pile up there and make sure they don't run the ball.
This is a big third down and about five, Coach, for Covcath and Lexington Catholic. The Knights have it at the 48 of Covcath. Goman, 4:08 to go here in the scoreless first quarter. Fake. Passes over the middle and diving for it and can't come up with it. Incomplete down to the 32-yard line. That would have been enough for the first down. And Mundy was the intended receiver.
Yeah, he had plenty of time to throw the ball. He pulled the trigger real quick on that one and just underthrew the ball.
Have you got any numbers yet on Mr. Goman? Any stats yet? I think he's probably completed, what, three passes by now? Four?
Well, he's had a couple thrown short, too.
Yeah, fourth down. 4:02 to go here in Lexington Catholic. They're in the blue, and Covcast in the white with the blue and the blue helmets.
Goman's 5 for 7.
Five for seven. Yeah, I thought he had about four or five completions.
31 yards. No.
Goman looking, passes, and almost intercepted, and it's knocked away. As that was number 30 there, Coach.
Darple.
Oh, almost got the interception.
Yeah, he would have had a nice little run ahead of him, too. So that was took a little chance trying to zip that ball in there.
Sure did. And to turn it over on downs, and Covcath will start at their own 49-yard line. So they'll have excellent field position and to try to score the first points of this football game.
Yeah, they haven't had much offense going yet. They threw that interception on the first play of the game and have not gotten very much done.
Twins to the near side. Schneider in motion. Jacob keeps it, and he tucks it down to the 45-yard line.
Yeah, that was a really good job defensively.
Lance Wasick came over to get him, Coach. And
Corbett. Yeah. Corbett actually submarined in there and took his leg.
Saw 67 in there as well. 67, Coach.
Yeah, 67. That's Patton.
Yeah.
Thomas Patton. I've been watching him on defense, too, a little bit.
Caleb Jacob picked up five on that last play. It's second down and five. Fire over the near side. Reardon knocked away. Good defense there. I tell you what, Woodall's doing a terrific job on Reardon.
Yeah, he is, and they're really playing this well. Seem like they have the Colonel scouted really well, Gary.
Yeah.
Of course, when you're 7-0, you have a lot of games you can watch, too.
Exactly. They've seen seven games.
And what was that scoring percentage?
They've outscored their last four opponents 206-10. To 10.
That's amazing. That's
3:22. The clock has stopped on the incompletion. Third down and five for Caleb Jacob. Motion to the far side by Schneider. And Jacob is going to tuck it, and he breaks a tackle, and finally he's going to be knocked down about the line of scrimmage. It'll be fourth down, and in there, who made that play, Coach?
Be number six for Lexington Catholic, which is Powell.
Jack Powell. Powell making the play, and that's going to send Woodall back deep, and Granati's going to come in and kick again. 2:55. Is this the second punt for Cupcat?
Second punt, and been all defense. Both
sure
of
has
teams.
On both sides.
This is good to see, though. Good battle.
So Granati set to kick. Waiting for the snap. Good snap. And a high, good punt. Woodall takes it in and dances up to the 20. He's coming to the 30, being chased, and then ran out of bounds. And they're making the stop. That is Adam Holtz.
Adam Holtz and Mr. Sideline made the stop.
Oh, yeah, Adam Holtz chased him to that 12th defender over there, sideline.
Okay, I'm going to make a prediction here. I'm watching that punter for Covington Catholic. He takes an extra step, a little hesitation, an extra step. If they see that and if they have a good block punt in, they're going to get one of those.
Well, this has been kind of an odd game. The Cubcats' first pass was intercepted by Bullock from the outstanding quarterback, Jacob. And Lexington Catholic's defense has been outstanding.
Yeah, little mistake here, though.
On their offense.
Yeah, little misstep here.
2:25 to go in this first quarter. No score. Covington Catholic and Lexington Catholic, two top-ranked teams. Lexington Catholic is number six in the state in 4A. Covcath number one in 5A football up there with Owensboro. Boy, Owensboro's got that quarterback back this year, Wimsatt. Man, he's a good one.
I've heard that, yeah.
And Frederick Douglass, an outstanding team.
And Catholic, the two South games Warren. They lost were a tremendous football team.
Lexington Christian beat them on a last-second field goal in Boyle County. Goman looking, fires it down the left side. He's got a receiver out there, and it's Buesen. It's incomplete.
Just overthrew that one. Just overthrew that one.
Blake Buesen was running just like he did last year. He just took off running down the middle, and Bo Allen hit him, and he went all the way for the touchdown. Remember that, Coach?
Yeah, oh,
did
yeah,
it twice.
Yeah. He could have gotten there one, too, if he had got the ball to him. Just overthrew him a little bit. Goman's got to get a little better control on those deep passes. I like him, though. Again, I think they can run some play action and get him established as a runner himself.
I tell you, they've had the ball three times, but they've been throwing incompletions. They haven't run much clock, have they?
No.
Motion by Blair to the far side. Here's a screen set up to the 35 and down to the 37, and he's tackled right there. And
that was an excellent play by Haynes, Luke Haynes. Excellent play.
David Sullivan, 82, came up and made the play. The linebacker, number two tackler on the team, David Sullivan.
Well, I just got the number wrong then. Yeah, 82.
Yeah, he's 82.
Right, 82. That was an excellent football play. He went right through the screen blocks to make the tackle.
Yep.
I apologize about that.
Oh, that's okay.
He turned sideways.
I didn't think you saw his number. It's hard to do everything, see everything up here in the press box,
yep,
Coach.
It is.
Blair goes in motion, now comes back to the near side. Goman back to pass. Goman fires it over the left side.
Nice.
It's caught.
Whoa.
To the 50, down to the 45-yard line. Blake Buesen with a nice catch and run down to the 45. Buesen.
That was Buesen, but that was Goman. That was one of the passes that he throws that I love the most. He throws that zipper right by the linebacker's ear, and he throws it on it's like a deep slant maybe.
Yeah.
And I'll tell you what, he throws that ball to a spot before that receiver makes the cut.
Yeah,
unbelievable.
He's, and just remember, Coach, he's a junior. He's back next year.
Does that boy play baseball?
Who, Buesen?
Yeah.
Basketball.
Goman.
Oh, Goman?
Yeah, he looks like a shortstop the way he's zipping that ball.
Yeah, I know he plays basketball. I don't think he plays baseball. Goman rolling to the right, looking, and gets it out to Buesen. And he is going to cut back at the 45 and get maybe the line of scrimmage back, and that's about it, because coming over to get him was the outside linebacker, Adam Holtz, 6 foot junior.
Yeah, Holtz does a good job. Normally Buesen will make that first guy miss, but not Holtz. He just made that a really nice stop. There we go again, Gary. They're second and long.
At the 45-yard line, triple receivers out to the top. Chase Blair is split in the backfield. Give to Blair up the middle. Loop running to the 40, and he's hit by the outside linebacker Holtz and drug back after he gets down to the 40. So it'll be fourth down, Coach. And what do you do if you're Lexcath? You got a fourth down at the Covcath 40 with just 9 seconds to go. That's going to run out the clock here in this scoreless first quarter.
Give him time to think about it.
So no score here in the first quarter. Lexington-Gavigan, Covington Catholic. We'll come back with the second quarter. It'll be the Knights football at the 40-yard line of Covcath when we return here on the Mingy Beef Jerky High School Football Game of the Week. We'll be back.
Some things never change. Like the sound of pads crushing against the equipment, the feel of cleats on fresh-cut grass, or the deep breaths from a full practice. Another thing that never changes, the feeling of relief when the whistle blows for break. And the savory snack to go along with it.
This is a moment to remember. This is a Mingy moment.
By the numbers, Whitaker Bank loves the Kentucky communities we serve.
There are 50 Whitaker Bank locations serving Kentucky communities just like mine.
61 Whitaker Bank ATMs throughout Kentucky make getting quick access to cash easy.
Whitaker Bank staff serves the needs of nearly 70,000 Kentucky customers every day.
We share your passion, Kentucky. Love the bank that loves you back. Whitaker Bank is uniquely Kentucky.
Third and about six, Gary.
Third down and about six for Lexcath at the 40-yard line. Goman back. Steps up, throws it. He's got a receiver there, and he overthrows him incomplete.
Yeah, okay. That's where he's having a little bit of a problem. He throws those short passes, those intermediate passes with a lot of zip and accuracy. But on those long passes, he's overthrowing the receiver. Actually, that time, he could have been able to hit the receiver between the corner and the safety, not by the safety. The safety's over there. He's got the angle.
And Darren Elder just checked in for the Knights.
They're going to go for it here.
Fourth down. They've gone for it a couple times down here, fourth downs. They are not going to punt the ball, it doesn't look like tonight. Second quarter action, no score.
That's not their quick kick formation either.
So. Woodall back in the pocket, rolling to the right, and Goman fires, and it's going to be incomplete.
I don't know about that decision. Nigel? You're playing good defense, but if you're playing really good defense like you are, back them up if you can.
So they turn it over on downs, and this time instead of at the 49, remember they started last time at the 49. Yeah. This time they'll start at the 40, so excellent field position goes to in the favor of Covcath.
Colonels are hungry for a score here. They're not used to being held to zero in the first quarter.
Well, they've outscored their last four opponents, 206-10.
Yeah. Spreading the field again, they did.
Binky comes to the near side. Reardon's out to the top. Motion by Schneider. Caleb Jacob firing, and he throws down the left side. Knocked away. Great defensive play there, Coach. We got to give kudos to that young man. That is Bullock, I believe. Bullock, who had the first interception of this game. Bullock got over and closed in a hurry.
That was a beautiful defensive play with Bullock.
Yeah, watch that. Saw it late there.
Just jump out and knocks it down. You know.
There it is again, Coach.
Yeah, let's watch his thing. It's a really decent pass. Look how nice pass on lead. He just gets that hand up on it. It would have been 6 points, Gary.
Yeah, he was outstanding. That saved a touchdown. So Caleb Jacob gives inside, and Collins to the 45, and then hit hard and knocked down, but made by Powell. I believe that was Jack Powell.
That was Jack
who came
Powell.
Up and he put the pow on him.
He put the powwow on him. I tell you, he put him to sleep. That was a heck of a hit. But you know, you talked about that runner. He'll run over you.
That Braden Collins. But Owen Nally, we haven't seen Nally tonight. He must be injured. He was listed as a starter. And he has been outstanding the last few games for Covcath. Twins out to the top. Binky's out to the bottom. Caleb Jacob, high snap. Gives inside the freshman, hit hard. And he's got the first down to the 49-yard line. and that was a freshman running that ball, Cameron Geisler.
He got every bit of that himself, too. He just powered up in there, ran right smack dab into the biggest part of the defense and got the extra yard.
Yeah, but that's impressive when you're a freshman.
Okay, they're moving the football here. Let's see what happens. The Knights are still in that man-to-man with a free safety, Gary.
At the 49-yard line. Geisler's got the handoff. He's to the 45 and upended right there. Young man played at Highlands for five games this year and then got his eligibility at Covington Catholic a few games ago and making the best of it.
There he is. He gets to the edge quickly. I'll tell you that right now. He gets to the edge very quick.
Corbin helped out on the stop for Lexcath. He got 7 yards out of that, coach.
Yeah, a lot of speed on the corner. Good blocking by the tackle on that side.
For you folks just tuning into this game, it kicked off at 7 o'clock, and it's 9:50 to go in the first half. No score. Jacob, left side, incomplete, and that's good pressure. Was that Wasik?
Wasik.
And I'll tell you who else it was in there, Elliot Movero. Movero making a nice play.
It was really a good job earlier putting the – putting the pressure on
Lance Wasik, the defensive end, got in there as well, but it was he and Movero who made the play there on the quarterback, Caleb Jacob. I don't think Jacob has seen this much pressure, coach.
No, that was really a good job too. And he short-armed the ball. He couldn't follow through with the throw at all.
Third down and 4. Schneider comes out with Garrett Binky to the near side, and a shift in the backfield. Jacob keeps it, and Caleb Jacob, and he's short of the first down. And who made – was that Lance Wasik?
I couldn't see. It was in the pile.
We'll just say it was. And fourth and about a yard and a half. They need to get to the 39. They're at the 41, so really fourth and about 2.
Do you think there will be a long count here? Maybe try
sure
to
there will.
Get Catholic Lexington Catholic.
Approaching
move.
9 minutes to go in this first half. Coming up at halftime, the UFOs, unheralded football overachievers. Jacob trying to draw Lexcath offside. Nobody jumping. Given the backfield, and he's got the first down.
Yeah.
Diving down, and let's see who. Was that Nally finally running the ball? Yes, it was. Finally, Owen Nally comes in and gets the big yardage and gets the first down, then he promptly goes out of the ball game.
I don't know what's going on with Owen.
Yeah, they're replaying almost every play, coach. Yeah. So I know we're away from that monitor, but
we'll try to look over there after the play and see what we can catch.
8:45 to go in this scoreless first half. No score between Lexington Catholic and Covington Catholic, two of the top teams in the state. Reardon splits out to the top along with Wilson. Garrett Binky to the near side. Schneider goes in motion. Caleb Jacob now. Gives to Schneider up the middle, down to the 35, and still running, and he's going to be stacked up inside the 35-yard line. And, coach, that was a 79 there for Lexington Catholic making that play. That is Duffy.
Yeah, Duffy's Quentin been in Duffy. Several plays. I'm really impressed with there's some battles going on out there, Gary. Seriously.
You like those offensive line and defensive line.
Oh,
the trenches, they call
they
it.
Oh, absolutely.
Second down at the 34-yard line. Schneider comes back to the backfield, shifts to the right of Caleb Jacob. High snap. Jacob fires a knockdown on a great play. And that's turned in there, coach, by number 1 for Lexington Catholic, Jackson Corbett.
Yeah, he got in there right away. A little blitz action going on. Nice job.
It's almost like he's going to catch the ball there for a second.
Yeah, I thought he was going to take it away from the quarterback. Corbin did a really good job. It looked like Dietz, the center, was blocking out, and Corbin just saw the hole.
Remember last year, coach, Covington Catholic had to score 14 points late in the fourth quarter to win that game up at Park Hills.
Yeah, it was a battle.
Third down and 5. For the quarterback, Caleb Jacob. He's looking right. Fires it over the middle and knocked away again on great defense. And here's a flag. And we'll have to take a look at that again, Coach.
Let's look at that again, Jack. See what we got. He was hanging on him with that left arm a little bit.
He got the left arm in there, didn't he?
So that'd be a he knocked the ball down with his right hand, but that left arm was around the waist.
Yeah. Of course, Lex and Gather people don't like to call, but they didn't get to see the replay like we did.
No, they didn't get to see the replay.
So that moves it down. That sets Covcath in business in the red zone now as they are going to be inside the 20-yard line. So first time tonight that Covcath's been in the red zone with 7:38 to go in the first half. Who would have thunk it, huh?
Who would have thunk it? Both teams. Big goose eggs on the scoreboard.
Covington Catholic, number one team in 5A. Lexington Catholic, number six in 4A. Bull County, number one, or Johnson Central, whichever poll you look at. Triple receivers to the far side. Geisler, left side, 15, 10, and bumped out of bounds at about the 8-yard line. Cameron Geisler.
Yeah, he's really impressive. I see what I got. You know,
he's only a freshman, Coach.
He just has that. He's small. It hides behind that offensive line, but he gets to the corner fast.
We've only seen Nally one time tonight carry the ball one time, the leading rusher, and he got the big first down.
Yeah.
Then he left the game.
He left the game.
Caleb Jacob.
Different running back in there.
That's Braden Collins. Jacob back in the pocket, fires left side, and it's going to be Reardon. And did he? No, he got down to the 1-yard line. He did not get in the end zone.
See that again, Jack. We'll see how close he got there.
Ethan Reardon, 6'5 receiver. Woodall pushed him out of bounds. So.
Oh, yeah. It was real close. It's probably closer than they have the ball spotted. It's probably 6 inches away.
Covington Catholic threatening here. Inside the 1-yard line.
Is the big man in there? No.
Yes, yeah, he is. Nally's in there along with Collins, yeah. Brady Collins.
That's a nice offensive backfield right there.
Yep. Jacob under center. And he keeps it, and he's going to dive in for the touchdown. Touchdown, Covington Catholic. Caleb Jacob, the 6'4 quarterback, that's pretty easy when you're 6'4 and you play high school football.
Yeah, and then when you have a guy behind you that runs up in, your rear end and pushes you over, too, that helps.
So Dave Granati will come in for the extra point out of the hold of Adam Holtz, the backup quarterback. Boy, A.J. Mayer, speaking of backup quarterbacks, but he lighted up for Miami of Ohio the other night. 3 touchdowns in the third and fourth quarter. That big victory for the Hawks, and the kick is up, and Granati nails it. One of the best kickers in the state going to Army. 7:19 to go in this first half, and that's the first score of the ball game. Covington Catholic 7 on a quarterback keeper by Caleb Jacob. They lead 7-0 over Lexington Catholic here at Joseph K. Ford Stadium. We'll be back on the Mingy Beef Jerky High School Football Game of the Week.
At Atkinson Center Commode, helping you through your financial situation is our only purpose.
We are involved at every step, guiding you towards relief. Take the first step and dial 859-CALL-ASK or visit ask-law.com to schedule a free consultation.
Welcome back here, and Covington Catholic scores first with 7:19 to go in this first half. Covington Catholic on a 1-yard touchdown keeper by the quarterback, Caleb Jacob, and they lead in this game 7-0 after the Granati kick.
Gary, the big play was the penalty.
Yeah, that was
a
huge.
Big penalty that moved the ball down the field.
Here's Granati's kick. Woodall is back deep at the 2-yard line. He comes out to the 5. He's at the 10, 15, 20. He's at the 30. He's got the kicker to beat, and Granati comes over and runs him out of bounds at the 43-yard line.
I know why he's going to Army.
Yeah, he's tough.
He's tough. That was an excellent job. Wow.
Man, he put pads to pads, and that saved a touchdown right there.
But that was a great run. I love those kickoff returns. Well, they don't hesitate, man. They just bust up in there.
Excellent field position at the 44 for Lexington Catholic and Jack Goman. First down, the football's at the 44. Covington Catholic just scored their first touchdown of the game. 7:12 to go in the first half at 7-0. Covington Catholic leading LexCav. And Goman wanting to toss it to Blair. He does. Blair up to the 40s, and a great tackle by the outside linebacker, Adam Holtz. Boy, Holtz came over and made a nice play.
We have some people watching the game, and I have a couple people that can't find it. They're on the site, but they can't find the game. They're on the Prep Spin site, but can't find the game.
Never heard of that before.
Yeah.
Just talking about LexCath and CovCath. Tell them to go.prepspin.com and click on the watch live. Here's Goman, passes it downfield, and Buesen's going to be interfered with. There's flags all over the place.
Yeah, that man.
As the young man gets up and says, "I didn't interfere with him." Well, you tackled him. So I think you did interfere with
him. Yeah, I would think so.
Yeah, the defender back there was that the culprit was a Danneman, Jacob Danneman, and he tackled Buesen at the 20-yard line. So interference will be called. So Lexington Catholic trying to tie this thing up. So you have the football. They mark it down with the penalty. You know, it's better to get that. That would have been about 20 yards downfield had he not tackled him.
All right.
That's exactly what Buesen did last year up at Covington Catholic, isn't it, Coach? He just took off running, and the ball was right there. They can also catch a game on Facebook. Here's a Blair dancing into the line and down to the 32. Good run by Blair. Picked up about 8. And finally he's stopped there. And coming in to get him was Ryan Schneider, the strong safety. That's a problem when your safety's making a play.
It is. That was a nice run, too. I like to see him run the football. I think Goman is such a good runner himself. Any play-action pass is going to be open.
Goman gives now to Eldridge, and he's down to the 30-yard line. Knocked back by Adam Holtz, the 180-pound junior outside line. Holtz has made a number of nice plays tonight.
Yes, he has. He's really, really very active in there.
I know the game's on, Coach, because a lady from Lexington Catholic came up and told us that she had some friends watching it. So I know it's out there.
Well, I've got a couple watching it and a couple that can't get it.
Third down and 2. Tell them to go to Facebook.
I know Prep Spin. I know the people I'm talking about don't have any Facebook. I'm going to tell you that right now.
Okay, tell them to go to go.prepspin.com.
Yeah, I have.
Into the line and running hard as hell, Eldridge, and is – he takes it down to the 20-yard line. Darren Eldridge. Good run there by Eldridge. Got the first down, and Lexington Catholic with 5 minutes and 15 seconds to go here in this first half. This is their deepest penetration. They're in the red zone now as Covington Catholic got it into the red zone for the first time and scored on a quarterback keeper from their outstanding quarterback, Caleb Jacob.
This is a good drive.
Eldridge into the line, down to the 15, and he bulls down inside about the 13-yard line. And coming up to get him there, that was saw 34, Robbie Sanfus. And, Coach, who else did you see in there?
Yeah, I think that was it. Really good job of blocking Nash and Duffy. Really good job on that right-hand side. Of course, Romero's outstanding center.
Yes. We got, of course, Lexington Catholic had some shifting on their offensive line. Jake Nash is a left tackle. Elliot Movero's a left guard. Romero is a center. Patrick Davis and Quentin Duffy. Give to Eldridge. Cuts it back. He's down inside about first down. Takes it down to the 10-yard line.
Yeah, they're like zone block. They're like right in the outside zone blocking, but he's getting to the corner and turning upfield.
David Sullivan, the linebacker, helped out on that play for CovCath. 4:05 to play in the 7-0 game. Football at the 6-yard line. Goman gives and running up hard, and a great play turned in there. And coach.
Yeah, 85. It looked
Trevor
like
Wilson.
Wilson did a super job. He grabbed the hold and pulled him backwards, trying to keep him from getting through that hole.
So brings up second down. Football at the 4-yard line. 3:30 to go in the first half. 7-0. Covington Catholic on top of Lexington Catholic, but Lexington Catholic threatening here at the 4-yard line.
Taking a long time to get this play in.
Yeah, too long for my comfort. Goman with Eldridge behind him. Buesen's out to the far side. And Goman, bad snap, rolls to the right, throws it, and it's a touchdown to Blake Buesen. He was wide open. Blake Buesen with a wide open. He was so open, he had to wait for the ball.
Yeah, we're going to look at that again. I'm going to look at this pretty close, where that receiver really came from. They had that trips going. Oh, okay, a choice route. The wide receiver took two steps inside, looked like he was running a slant, and then broke back outside. He was uncovered.
Blake Buesen loves playing against Covington Catholic, doesn't he?
He does, doesn't he?
Another touchdown catch against Covington Catholic.
He's had pretty good luck, that's for sure.
He had two last year. That's his fourth touchdown this year in only seven ball games, so it's not like they've played a full schedule. So DeGraff's extra point. Kick is up, and is it through the left side? Just got in the left side. So 7-7. Lexington Catholic drives down and on a Goman to Buesen touchdown pass of 4 yards. They tie it up 7-7. 3:10 to go in the first half here at Lexington Catholic. We got a good one here tonight between two of the top teams in the state. We'll be back.
That's right. That's the way.
This is where it all started, right here on this farm. We may have grown over the years, but we've never lost sight of what was important to us. We're continuing that tradition today, and we always will be, for generations to come.
Welcome back to Lexington Catholic, where the Knights just tied it up, 7-7. 3:10 and coach will give you some stats here as soon as we get this kick. And it's going to be taken by Geisler at the 10. He's up to the 15. The freshman up to the – and he's hemmed in and
nice
knocked
job
down at the 16, 17-yard line.
They do a fantastic job of coverage on the kicks.
And, coach, you got some numbers
yeah,
there.
Goman's 9 for 15 for 58 yards and a touchdown. Pretty good. The longest pass was 18 yards. And then for Covington Catholic, Jacob 2 for 9 with one interception game.
Yeah, the first pass of the game was intercepted by Teddy Bullock.
Yeah, and as far as rushing goes, Eldridge 5 yards. Pretty much that's it for Lexington Catholic.
Coach, you commented on the crowd over there along the way for Covington. They got a lot of people in here.
Yeah,
they all got masks on. Looks like they do.
It's 27 yards for Eldridge.
Jacob rolling to the left. Looking back, coming back inside, and he's going to be looking, and throwing incomplete.
Man, he had plenty of time to throw the ball. He's scrambling back and forth. Eldridge is 6 carries for 27 yards, and that's the leading rusher for Lexington Catholic and the leading rusher for, 20 yards for Braden Collins and Geisler. So.
That incompletion, coach, at the seven stops the clock, 2:54 to go in the first half. Lexington Catholic 7, Covington Catholic 7 here. A big battle here. What a way to end the regular season, huh?
Yeah, I'm excited about this. This is a defensive battle. We don't see defensive battles very often. But
Kevin Brueggemann has done an outstanding job with his defensive unit. And, of course, Nigel Smith's a defensive guy, too, the head coach. Motion by Schneider away from us. Caleb Jacob. Long count, back in the pocket, sets it up, throws it, and it's caught by Collins up to the 19-yard line, slam back. And who got him there, coach? Is that number five? If that's number five, that's Klein, Jackson Klein.
I think Jack Monday? Yeah, Jack Monday was in there.
Well, he's 23.
Yeah, he was in there right
that
there.
That looked like number five to me. 2:22 to go in the first half. This game started at 7 o'clock. It's 7-7. Number one, Covington Catholic in 5A. Number six in 4A, Lexington Catholic. Good battle here tonight at Joseph K. Ford Stadium. Gary Ball, Mike Meehan. And he's going to run up the middle and be stopped. And who got him there, Coach? Is that Lance Wasick?
Wasick on the bottom of the pile.
Yes, sir. Lance Wasick.
Yep. And again, I'm telling you that one of the best players today as far as what he's doing is Thomas Patton. He's on offense and defense, Gary.
So that'll force a punt by Covington Catholic.
All right. Now, I'm telling you, this punter, he's a little slow.
Yeah, you've been talking about that all night. So Dave Granati, punting back inside the 10-yard line. Needs a good snap here. Gets it and gets the punt. And it's shanked. Almost blocked and returned, and Woodall down to the 35, still going down to the 31-yard line. What a return there by J.D. Woodall.
Excellent job. And I'll tell you who put the heat on the punter and caused that bad punt was for Lexington Catholic, number 10.
Number 10 for Lexington Catholic, Coach, yeah. And that is Jack Malley.
Malley did a nice job.
So that's a chop block, so that'll hurt them. That'll move them back. So they get a great play and a great return, and they get a chop block.
I don't know. I don't think it's a chop block.
That's what the
block below the waist, maybe, but a chop block is something completely different. That's a line of scrimmage.
Yeah, I think he said the wrong thing.
Although maybe they changed the terminology. It's hard to keep up with that, too.
At the 43-yard line, so minute 9 to go in this first half. Gary Ball, Coach Mike Meehan. Jack Haynes, our producer, the Prince of Stream for the King tonight. In for the King. Triple receivers out to the top. Ooh. Now he'll send Blair in motion. Back in the pocket. Blair wide open. He gets it to him. Blair around the right snap to the 40-yard line. And Blair, does it get out of bounds? I believe he did, at the 40. So
tackled by about three defenders, defensive backs over there. He was wide open on the throw.
There was a lot to do about nothing. And only picked up about 3 yards.
Yeah, and he was so open.
He was so open, but it closed in a hurry.
Yeah, as soon as he started downfield, every secondary guy that was over there kind of collapsed on him. But again, that was trips. They had trips to the wide side of the field and then motioned the player to the wide side of the field. So there's quads over there.
Corbin and Kleiner to the bottom. Buesen's out to the top. Goman looking to the sideline with 59 seconds to go. He sends a Blair in motion to the left side. Goman steps up. Goman and down to the 39-yard line. Picks up a couple of yards. And there to come up and get him was Max Lowry, the nose tackle. He is a 6-foot, 230-pound sophomore, Coach.
Nice. They just called – Lexington Catholic called timeout.
Why not? You can't take him to the locker room with you.
Right. 52 seconds. There's plenty of time to get the ball down the field with that passing game that they have.
Boy, so what a dandy. This has been a defensive struggle here tonight. Not struggle, but both teams have played good defense. But I tell you what, Caleb Jacob has not really had his usual night tonight, the quarterback for Covington Catholic. But Goman is really starting to pick it up here.
Goman's starting to pick it up. The running game for Lexington Catholic has picked it up too. And I think the Colonels are having a little trouble trying to get that ball downfield. They threw the interception on the first play of the game.
Yes.
And that's kind of backed them off a little bit.
Yeah, Teddy Bullock.
But there were some super defensive plays.
Teddy Bullock's played great in the secondary tonight. He got that interception, as you said, the first pass of the game. And he knocked another one down in this quarter.
Yeah, it was an acrobatic play knocking the ball down.
52 seconds in the half, 7-all. Lexington Catholic on the march. Giving to the line, Eldridge, and he's to the 35, down close to the first down marker, and I think he's got it with that mark. He's got the first down to 33. Darren Eldridge, first down for the Knights.
That was nice.
They've got a timeout left here, so They got two timeouts left, don't they, Coach? Yeah, they do. Two timeouts left for the Knights is what they got up on the scoreboard anyway. Yes, I know they've only called one.
Yeah.
So, Goman back, firing over the left side, and he's got the catch, trying to get outside, and he can't get out. What a play there. Turned in, and that's turned in by one of the cornerbacks, Jacob Daneman.
Jacob Daneman got those legs and kept him from getting out of bounds. That would have saved the timeout if he would run out of bounds.
Yeah,
he didn't, so.
Yeah, you got to get out of bounds there, Coach.
You do.
If you're Blair, you don't worry about that defender. You go ahead and get to the sideline.
Get to the sideline, stop the clock. You save that.
It's like he waited for the contact to come to him.
Yeah, they got a decent field goal kicker, so they just need to get down in field goal range.
Yeah, both teams have outstanding. Granati's one of the best kickers in the state.
We've actually seen some really good kickers.
Yes, we have. The kid over at LCA, Dobbs, who didn't play in the game.
I know.
He didn't play in the game against Pikeville, the game we did last Friday. That was two number one ranked teams, number one in single A and number one in double A. And Lexi Christian got the win. And Marty Moore's kid, Mason's pretty good.
Pretty good.
He's outstanding. Got a pick six in that game.
Goman's 11 for 17 right now.
Goman 11 for 17. He has Eldridge in the backfield with him. Second down and nine. He's rolling to the right. He's looking, and he's going to fire it. And just toward the sideline, he was out of the tackle box. So it'll be third down and nine with 19 seconds to go in the first half. Here at Lexington Catholic, Gary Ball with Coach Mike Meehan and Ty Schott and Jack Haynes, the producer extraordinaire tonight for William. William is on assignment.
Yeah, he's on assignment somewhere, Coach.
He's on assignment. And I notice he's got the best equipment on the assignment, too, anyway.
Hey, Jack, I'm getting comments from a couple of people that my mic's not working well. So you might want to check and see if there's.
Well, you got to get that mic right up there, Coach.
No, I don't think it's that. I think it's a little echo thing.
Oh, okay. I got you.
I don't know. I'll find out.
Goman looking downfield. He's got a receiver, and he's got the catch and touchdown.
Nice throw.
Touchdown, Jackson Corbett.
Right down the middle, Gary.
What a throw by Goman.
Perfect throw. Right over the shoulder. Next catch.
32 yards from Goman, and, man, that was a perfect. That's Bo Allen-like.
That was beautiful. Beautiful throw.
So they score with 12 seconds to go in his first half, and Lexington Catholic takes a lead here. Of course, they had a lead on Covington Catholic. Last year, they led by 13 points in the fourth quarter. So here's DeGraff's extra point that will put the Knights up 14. What a throw by Mr. Goman. Kick is up, and it is nice a kick. Beauty. 14-7, Coach. 12 seconds to go in this first half, and Lexington Catholic leads the number one ranked team in the state, Covington Catholic, 14-7 here. On the Mingy Beef Jerky High School Football Game of the Week. So,
high school sports have evolved thanks to Prep Spin. Tonight, catch all the hard-hitting action live HD video. Join us tonight for the Mingy Beef Jerky High School Football Game of the Week with the legend Gary Ball, Coach Mike Meehan, and the king of stream, William Moorfield. Nobody does high school football like Prep Spin does. The Mingy Beef Jerky High School Game of the Week comes your way now.
Cameron Geisler and also Garrett Binky back deep. Here's a low kick, and it'll be taken by Geisler at the 18 to the 20, 25, 30. He's running to the far side. He's got the kickers back there, and he's going to be shoved up against the sideline out of bounds.
Wow, I tell you what, that was a really good run now. Again, that gives them good field position, Gary. Here we are. There's only, 4 seconds to go? That's enough time for a long pass down the field? Maybe get an incompletion? I mean,
Got Ethan Reardon. They got Reardon at 6'5", Coach.
Yeah.
Receiver. And he had to catch down near the goal line. It got called out of bounds at the 1. You said it was more like 6 inches. And
yeah, it was. It was really close.
Then they scored on the next play. So 4 seconds in this first half, 14-7. Lexington Catholic on top of number one team in the state in 5A, Covcat. Caleb Jacob rolls to the right, sets up, throws it deep downfield, and it's going to be intercepted. And it's going to be brought back to the 20, to the 30, 35, and 38-yard line. It's going to do it, and it's picked off. That is Corbett, I believe.
Yeah.
Jackson Corbett.
He's fired up, boy. He's got everybody fired up.
So upset brewing here at Lexington Catholic as the Knights on top of Covington Catholic 14-7 here at halftime. And we got the UFOs coming up. Coach, we'll take a break. Come back with your UFOs and some stats here. Well, great job tonight by Jack Haynes producing. And Ty Schott with the camera work. 14-7.
And thanks to Kenny Bourne, too.
Yeah, and Kenny Bourne providing the stats. 14-7. That's a second pick tonight by the quarterback, Caleb Jakey, threw the first pass, was intercepted by the Lexington Catholic Knights, and that was picked off by Corbett. So 14-7 here at halftime. We'll be back with the UFOs and halftime here at Lexington Catholic with the Knights lead. The Colonels of Covington Catholic 14-7 on the Mingy Beef Jerky High School Football Game of the Week.
Same MRI, same CT scan. Same items, different prices. So why would you pay more for the same thing? Lexington Diagnostic Center and Open MRI can save you 30 to 60% compared to the costs of local hospitals. We have a state-of-the-art facility in the Lexington area. We believe that every patient deserves the best in affordable, quality care. Avoid surprise billing. Come to Lexington Diagnostic Center, imaging focused on you.
This is Gary Ball for Crown Trophy of Lexington. Crown Trophy offers youth sports awards, corporate awards. They offer signs and a full line of promotional products. They're located at 2680 Wilhigh Drive on the corner of Nicholasville, New Circle Road, just behind Starbucks. Stop by and pick up your copy of our 85-page catalog. Crown Trophy is nationally known, but locally owned with 150 stores nationwide. Crown Trophy, the official provider of plaques for the Scholastic Ball Report and Preps Pen.
Same apples, same phone, same coffee, same items, different prices. So why would you pay more for the same thing? Lexington Diagnostic Center and Open MRI can save you 30 to 60% compared to the costs of local hospitals. We have a state-of-the-art facility in the Lexington area. We believe that every patient deserves the best in affordable, quality care. Avoid surprise billing. Come to Lexington Diagnostic Center, imaging focused on you.
By the numbers, Whitaker Bank loves the Kentucky communities we serve.
Whitaker Bank supports 496 Kentucky schools.
Over 282,000 students benefit from Whitaker Bank's Kentucky education initiatives.
Whitaker Bank has contributed almost $441,000 to education programs for the advancement of Kentucky's youth.
We share your passion, Kentucky.
Love the bank that loves you back.
Whitaker Bank is uniquely Kentucky.
Same shoes, same mixer, same computer, same items, different prices. So why would you pay more for the same thing? Lexington Diagnostic Center and Open MRI can save you 30 to 60% compared to the costs of local hospitals. We have a state-of-the-art facility in the Lexington area. We believe that every patient deserves the best in affordable, quality care. Avoid surprise billing. Come to Lexington Diagnostic Center, imaging focused on you.
Folks, this is Gary Ball, and you hear my catchphrase, soup and a sandwich. When I want the best potato soup and prime rib sandwich, I head over to Rafferty's Restaurants after my games. Check out Rafferty's 9 great locations throughout Kentucky, and all you teens, you can eat at Rafferty's before those big ball games. The open prime rib sandwich is what legends are made of. Ask Joe B. Hall, the legend himself, it's his favorite. Rafferty's a big supporter of high school sports throughout Kentucky. Rafferty's, where the special is you.
Some things never change. Like the sound of pads crushing against the equipment, the feel of cleats on fresh-cut grass, or the deep breaths from a full practice. Another thing that never changes, the feeling of relief when the whistle blows for break. And the savory snack to go along with it.
This is a moment to remember. This is a Mingy moment.
By the numbers, Whitaker Bank loves the Kentucky communities we serve.
There are 50 Whitaker Bank locations serving Kentucky communities just like mine.
61 Whitaker Bank ATMs throughout Kentucky make getting quick access to cash easy.
Whitaker Bank staff serves the needs of nearly 70,000 Kentucky customers every day.
We share your passion, Kentucky. Love the bank that loves you back. Whitaker Bank is uniquely Kentucky.
At Atkinson Center Commode, helping you through your financial situation is our only purpose.
We are involved at every step, guiding you towards relief. Take the first step and dial 859-CALL-ASK or visit ask-law.com to schedule a free consultation.
This is where it all started, right here on this farm. We may have grown over the years, but we've never lost sight of what was important to us. We're continuing that tradition today, and we always will be, for generations to come.
High school sports have evolved thanks to Prep Spin. Tonight, catch all the hard-hitting action live and in real time as the game happens in 1080p HD video. Join us tonight for the Mingy Beef Jerky High School Football Game of the Week with the legend Gary Ball, Coach Mike Meehan, and the king of stream, William Moorfield. Nobody does high school football like Prep Spin does. The Mingy Beef Jerky High School Game of the Week comes your way now.
Welcome back to Joseph K. Ford Stadium on the campus, on the beautiful campus of Lexington Catholic High School, where tonight's game is a winner. It's a tough one. 14-7 in favor of the Knights at halftime. Gary and I are enjoying this. It's a great defensive battle, and we're just loving being here. It's a beautiful night and one of those games where we're excited to see what the second half looks like. But before we get to the second half, we're going to do what we always do, and that is we do our UFOs, our unheralded football overachievers. And I'm repeating myself, but I'll do it again, that over the years, in about 34 years of coaching that I did, there were so many people I noticed who did so much for the program, and they were always in the background, and nobody ever talked about them. They didn't get any attention. So what we try to do is we try to draw attention to these people. Now, a lot of times they don't like it. They don't want the attention, but we're going to give it to them anyway, whether they like it or not. So I talked to the two coaches, one from each team, and they gave me the name of somebody who they want to be the UFO, the unheralded football overachiever. I'm going to read this one because it's lengthy, but it's really, really good. This is from Coach Eddie Evanson from the Covington Catholic Colonels. His UFO, here is what he wrote. Due to the pandemic and everything that has changed regarding the logistics of education this year, I think it is fitting that a tribute go out to our principal, Bob Rowe. His leadership during this whole thing is not surprising at all because he has always been a great leader. But in my opinion, his proactive approach in doing what is best for the school and ultimately each kid has been admirable. Due to his wife being a hospital nurse, he understands the seriousness of this pandemic, but that has not blinded his vision of educating these kids the best way possible. He believes every problem has a solution. In order to reach that solution, you might have to put a ton of work in and that's out of the ordinary. And he will be the one doing the heavy lifting and putting the extra time it takes to make sure things are done right. Mr. Rowe has very high concern for the physical well-being of our students, but also a very high concern for their mental well-being, which may be more important than during this pandemic age. And he has no problem working day and night so that these kids can have as much as a normal high school experience as they can and still stay safe. Very impressive. And Mr. Rowe, if you're listening, congratulations on being a UFO, an unheralded football retriever. This was written by Eddie Evanson, and in his heart, you can tell he's expressing his true feelings to you about what you mean to this program and to all athletic programs at Covington Catholic High School. I think it's pretty amazing when you have leadership like that, for sure. All right, now we have the second UFO. We're going to go to Nigel Smith sent me Lexington Catholic's UFO. His UFO is the strength and conditioning coach, Ron Kelly. Now, I'm telling you what, with this crazy age, this really weird thing that's going on with this COVID, the conditioning coaches and the trainers have a much, much added responsibility for sure. Here's what Nigel Smith says about Ron Kelly. As so many things have been abnormal this year, preparation for football season while dealing with quarantines and social distancing and sanitation have caused such a shift in plans, especially in physical preparation. The structured off-season did not happen. So in other words, their normal off-season of conditioning, weightlifting, and so didn't happen this year. And when we were able to get back and have some activity, there were limits and changes. Coach Kelly's ability to plan and maximize what we were able to do this year from a strength and conditioning perspective has been amazing. Now, for one who knows that one of the most important people on these teams is the strength coach, conditioning coaches, the ones who keep these guys in shape in the offseason. Well, they didn't have an offseason this year. And because of that, it's really, really tough to get these guys in shape and do the right thing because you can't rush into it. You have to make sure that it's done correctly. So congratulations to the Nigel Smith and the Lexington Catholic Knights, Ron Kelly, Coach Ron Kelly, for being the UFO, the unheralded football overachievers for sure. I want to say hello real quickly to a couple people watching. My granddaughter, Kaya Meehan, down in Montgomery, Alabama. And Kaya,
Roll Tide,
having a good day.
Roll Tide.
Roll Tide, yeah, right, Roll Tide. and then also, of course, to Dennis Morbido up in Pittsburgh, PA, one of my all-time best friends.
Yep.
And he's watching it and hopefully enjoying himself. And then again, if Dr. Farley can get on, hopefully Dr. Farley will be watching and enjoying it also.
Yeah, he can go to YouTube and type in prep spin and probably get on YouTube.
That's what I suggested. So. Halftime statistics, Gary. I want to look at Lexington Catholic first. Let's take a look at passing. Jack Goldman, 12 for 19, 93 yards and 2 touchdowns. That's a pretty good half.
Yeah, pretty good half.
Pretty good half. Caleb Jacobs, maybe not so much. 3 for 12 for 2 interceptions. That last interception was just a throw for the end zone with 4 seconds left.
And then Lexington Catholic made it hurt by scoring that touchdown there and with 10, 12 seconds to go.
Yeah, that was pretty amazing. So, and then, of course, rushing. there have not been a lot of rushing yardage in this game. For Covington Catholic, Cameron Geisler has three carries for 20 yards, and Brandon Collins, 5 for 20 yards.
And they don't even have Nally on there. He did run the ball for that first down, so he did run the ball one time. But Nally's the best rusher for CovCat.
Right, and they're holding him out for some reason. We don't know. It's not like he's hurt. He came in there and looked healthy.
I bet we see more of him in the second half.
We might. This game's pretty important as far as reputation goes.
And, of
if
course,
you're rated number one.
One key thing, I'll let you get through the stats there, is you know CovCat will kick to LexCat because they defer.
That's really big right there. Darren Eldridge, 6 carries for 33 yards for Lexington Catholic, and Blair's 5 for 21 yards. Jackson Corbett has a carry, and Goldman, of course, has 1 carry for 2 yards. Receiving, Corbett, 4 catches, 51 yards. Buesen, 4 catches, 31 yards. And for Covington Catholic, Schneider, just 1 catch for 14 yards. That's a surprise, really.
Yeah.
So that's pretty much it. Real quick at the tackles, leading tackler for Covington Catholic looks like it is Sullivan and Holtz. And the leading tacklers for Lexington Catholic is the one we call a lot, Jackson Corbett. And Woodall also.
And, Coach, you want me to do the scoring, correct?
Please, please.
So here's how the scoring looked in the first half of action for CovCat. They scored first. That was 7:19 to go in the first half. Caleb Jacob went in 1 yard out on the quarterback keeper. The Dave Granati kick made it 7-0 in the ball game. And then with everything came for Lexington Catholic with 3:10 to go, 3 minutes to go in the first half. Blake Buesen hauled in a 4-yard. He was wide open in the corner of the end zone from Jack Goman. DeGraff's kick made it 7-7, and then they got the interception, and then they completed with a Jackson Corbett 32-yard touchdown pass from Goman. DeGraff's kick made it where we stand right now, 14-7, Coach. Lexington Catholic on top in just a really good quality football game to end the regular season. And this is why you got number one in the state, Covington Catholic, in 5A, and number six in the state in 4A, Lexington Catholic. You have battles like this when top 10 teams play.
Yeah.
You know?
And we watched number one in the state in 2A with
LCA.
LCA. And who's number one in the state with 1A?
Pikeville.
Yeah.
They battled last week. We had that game. When it's a quality a game, a good matchup, we have it right here on Prep Sports.
We have had every one of them.
And we got the playoffs beginning next Friday night. We're not sure where we're going to be next Friday night because I know Bourbon County officially, I think, just called off their football season. So they won't be playing a playoff game. So I know Lexington Catholic may not have an opponent. I know Anderson County is supposed to play Boyle County. So Lexington Christian will be in action. And, of course, we can't do a lot of the public school games because of the those Pixelot cameras.
Yeah, I know. That's another story. We'll see how that
ends
up. Well,
there was a story about it in the paper in September, so it's already been written about and documented. And, for some reason they gave them exclusivity. We don't understand that one, but that makes no sense. But we've been doing this for how many years now?
Quite a few.
We should have got grandfathered in, shouldn't we?
Grandfathered in.
Yeah, I mean, you're a grandfather.
Yeah, I'm a grandfather, yeah.
So we're set for the second half of action. I've got my light on my phone. And Coach,
are you excited about this?
Oh, yeah. This,
I am really excited about this second half.
I just see CovCat trying to make a really strong comeback here in the second half. Just look at what they did last year. Of course, they had a player last year named the Mr. Football named Michael Mayer, and he was a difference maker. He was a difference maker in that game up at CovCat last year.
What they say, a player like that doesn't come around very often.
He's a generational player.
Yeah, he's a generational
player. And kind of like Sean Alexander up at Boone. I know you knew I'd bring him up.
Yeah, you always do.
Generational player.
Just
like Ben Meehan was a generational player.
Ben was a generational player.
So Granati is set to kick off, and back deep is Woodall for Lexington Catholic. 14-7 here. We're starting the second half. Lexington Catholic on top, and they lead Covington Catholic, number one ranked team in 5A, up there with Owensboro and Douglas. Frederick Douglas and South Warren. Those are the top four teams in the state of 5A. Here's the kick to the near side, and I think it's going to go, and Woodall will bring it out at the 5. He's out to the 10, and he's got some room. He's got a seam out to the 30, and there's that kicker again. Granati put his shoulder into him at the 45-yard line. Granati, that's the second time tonight he saved a touchdown.
Granati saved that touchdown, and Charlie Sora a senior came in there also to help make
He was just cleaning up. Granati was right there on him.
He was waiting for it, wasn't he?
Yeah, David Granati. I tell you, I know his dad. He's the athletic director and soccer coach at Notre Dame. He's a great guy, and he's I know he's proud of his son tonight. He saved two touchdowns.
Notre Dame College or Notre Dame?
Notre Dame Academy. He's the athletic director at Notre Dame Academy.
Oh, gotcha.
Up in Northern Kentucky, across from Park Hills.
Right.
Inside handoff, Elders running up the middle, up to near midfield, and he's going to be tackled right there. And who came up and got him there? And I see a 51 in there, Coach.
And I don't think anybody saw it. That was too quick. They jump up so fast, too. They're really excited.
Peter Rice looked like he helped out on the play. Pick up of 4, second down. Long look for the play on the sideline from Goldman. Triple receivers to the bottom. Buesen's out there. He's already got a touchdown catch in this game. He had 2 last year against Covgath. Eldridge gets a handoff in motion going the other way, and he is going to take it down near the 46-yard line. He'll be short of the first down.
Yeah, that was a pretty good job there, too. And the tackle was made by Worth, Dallas Worth, 5'10", 160-pound junior.
So Worth made that tackle. Third down and 2 for Lexcat. 10 minutes and 45 seconds to go in the third quarter. Lexington Catholic leads Covington Catholic 14-7 here on Prep Spin, the Mingy Beef Jerky Game of the Week. Inside handoff, and he's diving down. I think he's got the first down.
Yeah, that was a nice job. One of the things Lexington Catholic, they have a formation that they use often. It's a bunch trips. When I see that bunch trips, I'm looking for them to really surprise the defense with a passing play where they weave those receivers in and out, and they're difficult to keep an eye on them. So we'll call that. When we see that bunch trips, we'll mention
that. That was Eldridge on that carry, by the way. Got the first down to the 45, and this time Goldman looking over. Eldridge is in the backfield with him. You got Corbett out to the top. Buesen's out to the bottom. Double tights. Eldridge shifts to the left of Goldman. Corbett comes in motion, and handoff goes and breaks a tackle on the backfield, and then he's gang tackled there. And
a host of defensive players.
You have a host of players. Lost about 2 or 3 yards on that one.
Yeah, it looked like Benjamin
Dickhouse
came up.
Yeah, we haven't called his name a lot tonight, have we?
No. And he's a good one.
Yeah. Leads the team in sacks with 7. He's a 6'3", 225-pound senior. And he's the right defensive end. They got a 4-man front going right now, Coach.
Yep.
Second down and 12. And Goldman fakes into the line, rolling left, looking, and he throws it incomplete as he was trying to go over on the left side to Jackson Klein, his intended receiver.
Well, yeah, and I think he threw it out of bounds, too, because the receivers were covered, and he's running to it. He's a right-handed quarterback running for his life left, and very difficult to make any kind of a throw there. So that's one thing I like about Goldman, though. He doesn't make those boo-boos. He doesn't screw up. Now, he had one bad game, I think we did, where he had some problems with
Boyle County.
Yes, but
he struggled in the Boyle
game. Yeah, he did.
But he's really a good quarterback, solid. Yeah. He had a great game against Tades Creek after the week after that. That's what you tell about. You can tell about a quarterback. What's your next game like?
Right. They had a illegal receiver downfield, and Covington Catholic declined the penalty, Gary.
Yeah, because it would give them the down back, right?
Yeah.
So it's third down and 12 for Lexcat. 9:14 to go in this third quarter. 14-7, Lexington Catholic leads Covington Catholic. Motion to the near side, and back to pass. Goldman, he's going to air it out over there. And
nice.
He's got his man, and he's going to take it down to the 35. Still going to the 20, and he's still going to the 10, and he's going to take it in. That's Jack Monday. That's Monday on Friday here.
That's a play of the year right there, man. We'll watch that again, brother. We'll watch that one again. Take that back all the way, Jack.
Jack Monday.
Let's take a look at that. Let's see how many tackles he breaks. Nice job on the flare. Wide open again. Check it out. One.
Tackle there. Two, three.
Three tackles.
Three tackles.
Nice job.
Monday. My goodness.
That was beautiful.
And that's a third touchdown pass tonight for Jack Gohman, and we still have 9:02 to go in the third quarter.
Yeah, the Colonels better wake up.
So here's the graph. And the kick is up, and he has plenty of leg. 9:02 to go in the third quarter. It's Lexington Catholic 21 and Covington Catholic 7 here. Jack Gohman and Jack Mundy just hooked up for a long touchdown pass that puts him up 21-7. We'll be back on the Mingy Beef Jerky High School Football Game of the Week.
Same MRI, same CT scan. Same items, different prices. So why would you pay more for the same thing? Lexington Diagnostic Center and Open MRI can save you 30 to 60% compared to the costs of local hospitals. We have a state-of-the-art facility in the Lexington area. We believe that every patient deserves the best in affordable, quality care. Avoid surprise billing. Come to Lexington Diagnostic Center. Imaging focused on you.
And DeGraff set to kick off, and he's into it at the 40. And it comes to Binky at the 2, brings it out to the 5, 10. He's to the 15. Garrett Binky up to the 20 and tripped up and dives up to the 23-yard line. 8:55 to go in the third quarter, 21-7, Lexington Catholic, Coach.
That was number 12 that jumped in there to make the tackle, it looked like. Yeah, yeah. Number 12.
Okay.
Okay, I've got a message for Gary Ball. One of my best buddies, one of the best coaches I know, Cisco Bryant. Cisco Bryant told me to tell you to quit bringing up flashback names like Sean Alexander. Cisco said I was a defensive coach, and he still has headaches from that dude.
Well, you know, we were talking about great players at Covington Catholic, too, and Eddie Evanston, certainly a great player at Georgetown. I got a comment. Here's a give around the right side. I believe that's Collins. There's a flag, and that's going to be probably holding. And I got a text from Darren Douglas. And Darren wanted to remind me that when Eddie Evanston, he was 44-1 as a starting quarterback at Georgetown College. The only loss was in the national championship game, and after which Eddie addressed the entire football team and told them as long as he was a quarterback, they would never lose again. Tiger, they went on to a 30-0 record and 2 national championships. So he lived up to what he told them.
Well, that's a man of his word.
That's
there.
Exactly right.
And he's a heck of a coach, too.
It's 21-7 here, and that's holding against – Cupcat, that's not hard to – when you see a flag coming from the back judge, that's not hard to figure out, is it?
No.
So 8:48 to go in the third quarter, and this is the Mingy Beef Jerky Game of the Week. It's 21-7. Lexington Catholic stunning number one. And, you know, Cisco Bryant, I tell you, what a great guy and a great coach. He's coaching now, and his son Ty Bryant's a really good player at Frederick Douglass.
Yeah, he'll be playing at the next level.
He's a Division I player, absolutely.
He's fun to watch.
Absolutely. Here's Geisler, and he's around the left side to the 20 and 25, dancing up to the 30, and he's got the close to the first down marker after he got the penalty back and more.
Nice job, really. Good job.
Cameron Geisler, a freshman.
Ty and Cisco, but the best athlete in that family is mom.
You got that right. Yeah. I used to have breakfast. Bridge and I would have breakfast at Frisch's, and we'd see Ty and Cisco and his family there quite often. I tell you, I used to run into a lot there at that Frisch's too. Was Jed Wills, him and his family. He could put away a breakfast bar.
I bet he could.
Second down and a yard. 8 minutes to go in the third quarter. 21-7, Lexington Catholic. Inside handoff, Geisler hit, and he's up to the marker. I don't think he got it, but it doesn't matter. It's only going to be third down. And Coach, tell us who made that play.
The whole defense, it looked like, jumped up in there.
Looks like number 3, Mafata, and also Lance Wasik.
There's a replay. Yeah, there's just a big pile. Looked like Wasik was in there.
Yeah,
for
it looked like Lance Wasik.
Yeah.
Third and about a yard. 7 minutes and 29 seconds to go. Third quarter action. Lexington Catholic and Covington Catholic. The Knights on top, 21-7. Jack Goman has thrown three touchdown passes in this game. We have 7:19 in the third. Caleb Jacob takes a snap and dives forward, and he's got the first down. Good effort by Jacob, getting that big 6'4 body, 215 pounds going.
Really nice job up there. Peyton Diaz, 6'2", 256 pound, the center. Just a really nice job of blocking. That's a big boy, too.
Yeah, he is. I noticed him, 70. He stood out in the pregame, number 77. He looks much bigger than 6'2", 270.
He does,
looks about 6'4".
He really does look.
He's a junior. Really the only they got Janet Juzik is a senior on their offensive line. First down. Jacob back to pass. Airs it out, and it's up in the air, and it's going to be incomplete as it's intended for Reardon. And that's good coverage back there again, Coach. We got us. Who's in coverage back there for Lexington Catholic? Let's see who that is.
Is that Bullock?
That's Bullock. That's Teddy Bullock.
Teddy Bullock.
No, let's see. That is not Bullock. It's not 10. It is – that's Woodall.
That's what I thought.
Yeah, you're right. It's not 10. It was 18.
I'm going to tell you, he was beat. I'm going to tell you that, Mr. Woodall. You were beat, but you gutted it out, buddy. You turned on the burners and caught up, man. That was an awesome job.
Second down and 10. Triple receivers to the near side for the quarterback, Caleb Jacob. Covington County keeper this time, right side, and he breaks a tackle at the 40 and caught up with there and making that nice play, and that's going to be big Quinton Duffy, 6'1", 290.
Yeah, he's had a really good game.
He played it. He stayed with that one, didn't he? That was a pickup of seven, third and three.
This is a big third down, Gary, for them. They really have to get into it here.
6 minutes and 12 seconds to go in the third quarter. Lex Calf and Cub Calf. The Knights 21, the Colonels 7 here. Knights defense has played outstanding tonight. So I give kudos to the secondary.
Oh, I do too.
Triple receiver to the near side for Caleb Jacob.
Man free again.
Inside handoff and dive. That's going to be Braden Collins, and he leaps up close to the first down marker. He may have it. He sure does.
Yeah, he had it. Yeah, that was a good hard run there too. But, again, it's really interesting that Dexman Catholic, I mean – as a run defense, they're strong. They're really good. They're barely getting these first downs, but you know they're going to have to. The Colonels are going to have to figure out a way to get the ball down the field on the passing game. Yeah. Maybe run some little crossing routes or something. Try to get these receivers open to get that man to man.
Yep. Blitz being shown on the outside. Schneider goes in. Motion. They give it to Schneider, and he is going to be hit and dropped back at the 41-yard line. Was that
good
John?
Defense.
Was that John Martin?
That was John Martin. Yeah.
JMS.
Yep. Sims did a great job on that. Nice job. They just can't. They're playing a really good defensive game here. They don't want to break down now. Just go ahead and keep playing the way you're playing.
Yeah, I wasn't sure John Martin was given to us tonight. I thought he was injured a little bit, but. He's obviously okay, Coach.
He was okay in that play.
Sure was. Second down and long. 13 yards for Covcath. Jacob fires, and there it's going to be caught up to the 48-yard line.
Short game.
And the catch was made there by Jones, Aiden Jones.
Yeah, the ball was thrown a little low. He had to dive for it. Again, that was what I just mentioned, that little crossing pattern. That's really good. The object, though, is to lead him into the grass,
into
the open area, and let him run down the sideline with it. But he's just underthrowing a little
bit. Brings up a third and seven. Third down and seven. We're approaching 4 minutes to go in the third quarter.
Yeah, this is a quick quarter.
Reardon splits out to the top. He's the deep threat for Covcath with that speed and that 6'5" frame. And Jacob looks out there, throws to Reardon, and he's down to the 40, down to the 37-yard line. And making the play there defensively was Jackson Klein, number 5, made the play, but not before Reardon We talked about it before that play, didn't we, Coach?
Yeah, we did. And Gary, that was your Klein made that tackle, and it was that's a hard tackle to make against that big man.
Yeah, he's 6'5" and 190 pounds.
I think they found a couple little weaknesses though, with those little short crossing patterns and so on.
Triple receivers to the near side, and Reardon's out to the far. First down at the 38-yard line. Jacob's going to keep it himself and hit and knock backwards. And Lance Wasick's in there. And who else is in there, Coach? I see 57 getting up off the bottom of that pile.
Yep, 57 and, yep, 57. Now, it was Wasick again. Lance is just playing a really good game out there. And it's a tough going in there. There's some big, strong linemen for the Colonels.
Second down and 8. Football at the 36-yard line. They've got to get down to the 28 for a first down. Wide out to the near side. Now motion coming toward us up here at Snyder. And Jacob back to pass. Throws it, and it's going to be broken up.
Two receivers in the same area.
Yeah, they ran the same area. That was Reardon, the big guy, and Snyder, the little guy.
I think Snyder probably shouldn't have been there because Reardon was ready to jump up and get that ball.
He sure was.
Yeah.
It's like, what's going on here?
I tell you, he was wreaking havoc inside his patent for the Knights. I'm watching this kid. He's on a mission tonight. I'm telling you what, he looks like he's got a chip on his shoulder.
Yeah, he's ticked off about something.
He is. He's pacing back and forth, and he's looking at him, he's growling at him, and he's ready to bite people. And that's
well,
man.
They just remember what happened to him last year in the fourth quarter.
Yeah. I like Patton, I tell you.
Triple receivers to the near side. Third down. Jacob fires it out now to Geisler, and he's to the 35. Hit and drop, and it's going to be fourth and about 6.
Fourth and 6, they're gonna go for it for sure.
Cameron Geisler hauled in that screen, and man, who made the play there? I see John Martin Sims roaming.
Yeah, they collapse on the ball so well. You know, they get there and get. You know, my defense coordinator Mike Wainscott said, "Go to the ball and get there in an angry mood," and I think that's what they're doing.
Fourth down and about 7, isn't it, Coach?
Yep.
Long 6. Reardon goes out to the top. Caleb Jacob rolls that way. And Reardon, and they're going to get the – and they're going to sack him. There comes a flag, though.
Face mask.
There's a flag. Yeah, he got the face mask, and he's upset about it. He's upset with himself that he did that. Yeah. And that's Mufata.
Yeah, that's one of those things that happened, though. He's so aggressive going for the ball, couldn't stop himself.
Yeah, but that's a face mask.
That's a big one.
Yeah, that's going to be huge against Lex Kath. Yeah. And they would have had him sacked back at the 45, Coach, and they would have had the football as well.
Yeah, that was a really good rush. So that won't be a first down, will it?
Right.
Or,
well, it looks like
close.
It's going to be, looks like they might have it. Yeah, they got it by a yard.
Yeah.
So to the 28-yard line, boy, just think they would have had the ball, and man, what an opportunity for Lex Cav.
Yeah, big guy. A big mistake there.
So gives Covcath the ball back. 1 minute and 42 seconds, and the clock moving here at Lexington Catholic. The Knights 21 and the Colonels 7. Garrett Binky is to the near side. He's a lone receiver out there. Caleb Jacob and keeper. And he dives down to the 23-yard line. Picks up about 5 yards on a keeper. Good job there by Jacob, the 6'4 quarterback. He was offered by Monmouth. He has not committed anywhere yet, but he will play college football, Coach.
Yep. Caleb Jacob, I think this is right. They have him 5 for 16.
Yes, sir.
42 yards.
And 2 picks. And
2 picks.
And big
yeah.
picks, too.
Yeah.
One of them was the first play of the game. Teddy Bullock went up and got it.
Yeah. It was beautiful. And then he came back and knocked one down.
Yeah.
Beautiful play.
Second down and 5. And now they shift in the backfield. They give to Collins, and he's to the 25 and to the 10. There's a flag down, and he is going to take it down near the goal line, but there is a penalty marker down. So, as they say, hold the phone.
Yeah, it's holding against Covington Catholic right there on the edge, right on the corner when he made the turn. We see that again, Jack. We can see if we can find the hold. These things are everywhere. Yeah, one of the big linemen had a hold of him, grabbed him from behind. We got things. I don't even know what these things are.
They plug stuff into it.
They plug stuff into
it's
it.
It's an adapter.
That was a technical term.
It's outlets.
One of them yellow.
It's for outlets.
It's one of them big yellow things.
Yeah, it's outlets. You tearing the press box down up here, Coach?
I am, man. I'm excited.
You are. Calm down now. Still got a lot of football left. Remember last year they led Covcath by 2 touchdowns with 7 minutes to go.
Yeah, I know. And I'm sure the Knights remember that quite well.
Sure they do. Triple receivers out to the left. Caleb Jacob looking out to the left. Takes a count. Second back to in the pocket. And he's going to throw it over the left side, and it's going to be a great catch over there,
man,
at the 15-yard line. And that was made by Trevor Wilson.
That was a
what a catch by Wilson.
Yeah, watch this. We're going to run that again. He just goes up and gets it. And coverage is pretty good on it, too. Look at that, Gary.
Yep.
Coverage is really good.
Yeah, they've been playing great in the secondary tonight, Lexcath has.
Yeah, they were
Wilson,
all down.
Wilson had to really go up and catch that one. And that's going to do it for the third quarter. So we're heading to the fourth quarter of action. And the Knights have a 2-touchdown lead. But Covington Catholic has the ball at the 15-yard line, first and 10, when we come back on the Mingy Beef Jerky High School Football Game of the Week.
Same apples, same phone, same coffee, same items, different prices. So why would you pay more for the same thing? Lexington Diagnostic Center and Open MRI can save you 30 to 60% compared to the costs of local hospitals. We have a state-of-the-art facility in the Lexington area. We believe that every patient deserves the best in affordable, quality care. Avoid surprise billing. Come to Lexington Diagnostic Center. Imaging focused on you.
By the numbers, Whitaker Bank loves the Kentucky communities we serve.
Whitaker Bank supports 496 Kentucky schools.
Over 282,000 students benefit from Whitaker Bank's Kentucky education initiatives.
Whitaker Bank has contributed almost $441,000 to education programs for the advancement of Kentucky's youth.
We share your passion, Kentucky.
Love the bank that loves you back.
Whitaker Bank is uniquely Kentucky.
Same shoes, same mixer, same computer, same items, different prices. So why would you pay more for the same thing? Lexington Diagnostic Center and Open MRI can save you 30 to 60% compared to the costs of local hospitals. We have a state-of-the-art facility in the Lexington area. We believe that every patient deserves the best in affordable, quality care. Avoid surprise billing. Come to Lexington Diagnostic Center. Imaging focused on you.
Welcome back. We start the fourth quarter with Lexington Catholic up 21-7, but Covington Catholic has the football first down at the 15. They give now to Geiser around the left side, and he is going to be tackled at the 11-yard line. And Coach, that was Malley,
Powell.
I believe.
Jack Powell, I think.
Jack Powell, yeah, number 6. Yeah. Powell came up and made the play.
Made a nice play on that.
So 11 minutes and 42 seconds remaining in this game. And right now, if you're just tuning in, Lexington Catholic leads number 1 in 5A, Covcat 21-7. Jack Goman, 13-21, 3 touchdowns tonight. Caleb Jacob gives the guys around the right side, and he's going to be tackled. Good play there, turned in. And that is Lance Wasick.
Wasick did a good job on that. Didn't it look like he turned the corner? It looked like he was going to get upfield and go to the end zone. But Wasick just made a save on that bad boy.
What a close there by Lance. 11 minutes to go in this football game. And third down and 5 at the 9-yard line for Covington Catholic out of Park Hills, Kentucky. Colonels have just been shellacking people the last 4 games, Coach. Really all see. Their close games were to Dixie and Beachwood this year. Those were the first 2 games of the year.
I haven't seen Nally in a while, though, you know?
Collins shifts to the left. Motion now by Wilson, who's a keeper, and Jacob's going to get it down to about the 5 or 6. So he is short of the first down.
It's fourth down.
So it's fourth down about a yard with 10 minutes, 20 seconds to go in this football game. And, Coach, this has been one of the better games we've done this year on the prep spin. We've done some great games.
Absolutely. This is a defensive coordinators lose some hair, get some gray hairs on these plays.
Now Nally's in there. Got a brace on that left leg. They give and tripped up, but he got the first down. Yeah. Good effort by Braden Collins. They had Nally in there blocking, and he got the first down.
Yeah, he actually, you said it right. He got tripped up, but again, he got the first down, but it looked like he was heading for the end zone. Somebody got a hold of his foot.
They've got Nally in there, and I'm looking at Nally's left leg. I've got binoculars on him, and he definitely has a brace on that left leg. So he's got some kind of injury to his left leg, Coach, is why he hasn't played much tonight.
Well, again, it's a out-of-conference game, and right at the end of the season, maybe they're just saving it.
This would be a signature win for Covington Catholic, for Lex Catholic, if they beat them tonight here at home.
It would be.
Lexington Catholic and give inside Nally, and he is caught from behind and tackled. And getting up off that pile, Coach, that was number five, Jackson Klein.
Jackson Klein again.
6 foot, 170-pound senior.
Yeah. We've called his name quite often.
Yes, and Corbett's name a lot tonight,
Corbett,
too.
Absolutely. Wasick.
Pierce Hall early in the game went out with an injury, I believe, didn't he, Coach?
Yeah, he limped out on the sideline. I haven't seen him.
Jacob gives to Nally, breaking it outside, and Nally is going to dive in for the touchdown. He broke the tackle in the backfield, Coach, and Nally gets in for the score for Covington Catholic, and that is his touchdown number 8 for Owen Nally.
We'll
Owen K. Nally.
Let's look at that again. Jack's on it, baby. Good job. Yeah, he bounces outside and breaks the tackle. Scoots in the end zone. Nice job.
So Covington Catholic has cut it down to 21-13, 8:48 to play.
We were bragging about Jackson Klein. He missed that tackle.
You can't get them all, Coach.
No, can't get them all, and that's a slipper runner. So
here's Granati, and the kick is up, and it is through. So with 8:48 to go in this football game, a Covington Catholic comes down and scores on a touchdown by Owen K. Nally from about 3 yards out, and it's 21-14. Lexington Catholic, the number 6 team in 4A, and Covcath number 1 in 5A. We'll be back on the Mingy Beach. We'll be back in 30 seconds here on the Mingy Beef Jerky Game of the Week.
Same shoes, same mixer, same computer, same items, different prices. So why would you pay more for the same thing? Lexington Diagnostic Center and Open MRI can save you 30 to 60% compared to the costs of local hospitals. We have a state-of-the-art facility in the Lexington area. We believe that every patient deserves the best in affordable, quality care. Avoid surprise billing. Come to Lexington Diagnostic Center. Imaging.
Back.
Welcome back here, and with Coach Meehan, Gary Ball, and Jack Haynes, Ty Schott. And boy, what an answer there by Cove Cath. They got right back. It's 21-14. They got right back in this game.
Yeah, and they're using a balanced rushing attack. Cameron Geisler has 43 yards. Caleb Jacob has 31. And of course, Collins has 28.
What about Nally? He scored the touchdown.
Yeah, Nally has 7 yards, but a touchdown. So
Granati set to kick off for Cove Cath. 8:48 to play. And he's into the kick, and it's Woodall.
It's high.
Coming out to the 5. He is out to the 10 and to the near side and up to the 20-yard line twice tonight. The kicker, Granati's, had to get him to save a touchdown, but that time Woodall's only able to get it out to the 20-yard line.
Yeah, that was a good play by Holtz making the tackle there. So. Well, it's 8 minutes and 43 seconds, Gary Ball, and just a 7-point lead. Catholic needs to mount a little drive here, don't they?
Yeah.
even if they can get down in field goal range, have a nice drive, pick up time on the clock.
Goman will send one wide out to the near side,
okay,
Coach.
Okay, there's trip bunch. That's a trip bunch.
They're bunched to, to the left. And Goman firing, and it is picked off. It goes to the hands of the receiver, intercepted. 26 got it there, and that's going to be picked off by Sora, Charlie Sora.
Sora picked it off. We're going to look at this on replay. Brought that receiver across. Oh, yeah, he was open too, Gary, on that crossing pattern, like a deep cross. And the ball just came off his hands. It looked like he threw it a little too high that time and ricocheted off his hands. It was the Whitney rule, we used to call it, which is that goes so against the
last drive by Covcat took about 12 minutes, didn't it?
Yeah.
Because they got the ball with about 9 minutes to go in the third quarter. Now they scored. 8:39 to go. Geisler right side. He is down to the 30 and cutting back and still running down to the 32-yard line. Pickup of 8 yards.
Tremendous job of blocking on the outside there by Wilson. Really nice job.
Cameron Geisler. Boy, the freshman.
I'm glad
he transferred over, aren't they?
Yeah. Wilson, 6'3", 188 pounds. Nah, he's bigger than that. That was a nice job of blocking downfield.
Ethan Reardon is split out to the near with Schneider. Single receiver out to the top for Cam Jacob. Looking right side, throws it, and it's going to be caught down inside the 20-yard line. Great catch there by Binky, Garrett Binky.
Yeah, nice job again. The coverage was pretty good on it too, but the ball was thrown just too well. Woodall on the coverage.
Down to the 20-yard line, so they are in the red zone once again. Covington Catholic can tie it up here if they score. Look like a different team right now, don't they, Coach?
They do. They smell blood, for one thing.
Jacob Schneider shifts to the right with Collins, and they give to Schneider. He's hit and dropped. A good play turned in, and that's a super play there by 54 for Robert Hall, I believe it was.
Yeah, it was. Mr. Hall, nice job.
Yeah, Robert Hall, what a play.
That's a big one, too. Second and long. That's not a position that the Colonels like to be in right now.
Yep. Approaching the 7-minute mark of this football game.
The clock's been ticking like,
yeah.
I'm telling you, man, this game's going fast.
And Lexington Catholic leads 21-14. They led by 14 points. They led by 7 points at halftime. Took that opening drive of the third quarter down and scored. Jacob, long count, gives to Collins, and he breaks the tackle and cuts it back to the 15, and then tackled right there by a host of people. And, again, there's Hall in there, and Lance Wasik's in there as well.
Wasik came right across down the line of scrimmage and getting that tackle. He did a nice job of running, though. He dodged a couple people right there at the end. Nice job. They have a good football team. There's no question about that.
Third down and four.
You think the Knights are having a little flashback from last year?
Well, I mean, they were, you know, if you're Eddie Evanston, if you do score here, do you go for two? They did last year.
They did, I remember.
Collins to the left of Cam Jacob. Binky to the left. Reardon, here comes Wilson in motion. High snap. He pulls it down, and Jacob's still running. Loses the football in the end zone, and let's see who gets on it there. It's a battle for it in the end zone. Covcast said they recovered it, and it's going to be a touchdown. They get on it.
Sometimes you're lucky. Sometimes it's better to be lucky than good.
We'll have to see. Take a look at that again, see who got on that for Covington Catholic.
All right, let's check it out on the replay. Nice run, though, wasn't it? Boy, he just bowled his way in there. Boom.
It's like he threw the ball in the end zone.
Yeah, actually. Yeah, number 11 scored.
Okay, that's Jones.
When we get that back again, Jack.
Aiden Jones.
Instead of going to commercial, let's look at that play again. And if you can slow-mo it, because somebody knocked it out.
And it is good by Granati, so we're tied. Yeah, let's look at that again.
We're going to try to see who knocked. Somebody punched it out of his hands. All right. there. See the guy on the other side. Number 11 picks it up.
Jones recovered it.
One more time. Can we do it? Maybe we can just give both of those numbers and we can get them, Jack. The one's tackling them and one punches it out.
So it's tied 21 all.
Yeah, not five. It's the other guy that punches it out.
Powell, Jack. What? Is that Powell? Powell looked like he punched it out.
Wasn't that pretty? What a play. A little bit of luck involved there.
Oh, yeah. Well, we're tied now at 21, Coach, with 5:42 to go. And this is number one in the state in 5A, Covington Catholic, who had to come back from two touchdowns to tie number six in the state in 4A, Lexington Catholic. 21-21, 5:42 to play. Of course, Lex Cath can get the ball here, maybe mount a drive and field goal or touchdown.
They've got a kicker capable.
They got a really good kicker.
Yeah.
DeGraff. So, Covington Catholic walking with a little bit more pep in that step now, aren't they, Coach?
They have some pep.
In the step.
Yep, and I don't think Lexington Catholic, the Knights just can't doubt themselves now. They've got to really be able to.
That's a really good kick, and that'll be a touchback. What a kick by Granada.
He was out of there.
In the back of the end zone.
Really, nice job.
That's a Division I kicker right there. He's going to Army.
Mm-hmm.
So this is Preps Big Coach. You haven't asked me about Sunday.
Yeah, what's going on Sunday?
We got Mercer County as the team of the week. They're number four in the state in their class. And we've got some scholar athletes from Boyle County soccer, girls soccer. And we got a feature and highlights from all the games on the Scholastic Ball Report. That's Sunday at noon on the CWKYT.
Good show, Gary. It's really been good this year. And I know it's been tough with the COVID stuff, but really good job.
Yeah, thanks to William Moorfield and all his technical know-how. Goman gives inside, and that's going to be Eldridge. He dives up to the 20. So they're trying to strip the ball is what they're trying to do. Covington Catholic's trying to strip it out of there.
This is the time. You know, you said something before the game, and I remember specifically you said this game's going to go how Goman goes. And this could be his chance now.
This is a coming out party here for Jack Goman. He's a great basketball player. There's no doubt about that. He's a good quarterback. Is he a great Bo Allen-type quarterback? We'll find out on this drive. 5:10 to go. Inside handoff up to the 25 and running him back, and that's a tackle by, I tell you, the young man who recovered the fumble for touchdown. That's number 11, Aiden Jones.
Yeah, Aiden Jones on that one too.
So they haven't thrown the ball yet. It's third down and four. 4 minutes and 48 seconds to go.
Don't get tight now. I mean, just go ahead and move. Throw the ball. Don't be nervous about interceptions. It was, one bad pass not going to make
it. It tipped off your receiver and went into the hands of the defender. Goman sends Elders and rolls to the left. Goman setting up, throwing deep, and it is going to be over the shoulder, incomplete. And the intended receiver was Jackson Klein.
I wonder if that was his only receiver down the field because it seems like, they could just work toward the first downs and get some time off that clock.
So Schneider is going to drive back deep. Lexington Catholic's played an outstanding football game with 4:25 to go. It's 21 all, and they're going to have to punt the ball, and all the momentum right now is in the hands of Covington Catholic. Punt, and that was close to being blocked. High punt, DeGraff, and
not a good punt.
Nope. 49 yard line, and that's all Covcath had to maneuver to take their lead in this game. And well, they jumped out to a 7-0 lead, but came back. Lex Cath came storming back, had a 14-7 lead at halftime, led 21-7 here, and then Covcath came storming back and scored two unanswered touchdowns and tied it up here, 21 all with 4:15 to play. Now they got the ball up near midfield.
Yeah, Uncle Moe's on their side right now.
No doubt about it.
Big receivers, Gary. Golly.
Inside handoff to Collins. He breaks it. Here's a flag. So he breaks it down to the 40-yard line. Still going down inside to the 38, but there's a penalty marker down back at the line of scrimmage. That's going to be holding against the Colonels.
It looks like holding. That's a break for the Knights. Knock them back a little bit. Now, if you can get a turnover, you know, just get a turnover here. Get a fumble or an interception or something. In the meantime, Covington Catholic, they want to drive the ball, Gary. They want to take some time off the clock. They want to drive the ball. They've been doing a really good job of running the football, getting first downs after first down. Don't get behind the chains like they are right now.
They only got a three-man front, so now Mufata showing blitz on the outside. He's coming. Yeah, he's coming from the outside. Motion to the near side by Schneider. And here's Jacob. He's going to keep it, and he's going to be tackled. Yep. And coming over getting Mufata, and I think that's Powell, isn't it? Yeah,
it's
Mufata and Powell.
Yeah, Mufata and Powell.
Second down. 3 minutes, 52 seconds to go in this football game. 21 all. Remember, at one point, Lexington Catholic led 21-7 over the state's number one ranked team in 5A, Covington Catholic.
This is an important series for both football teams right here. Catholic wants to get good field position. If they can force a punt and get – they have good returners. Woodall back there, he can return the ball the length of the field.
Reardon splits out to the bottom. He's got Woodall on him. Jacob, second down and 17. Rolling to the right. He's throwing, and it's going – oh, it's broken up. And, well, a good break on the ball over there. And that was number 20 over there, Coach. And that is going to be Teddy Bullock. Bullock broke on the ball. He nearly came up with another interception.
Yeah, I thought he was going to get that one, too. He dove for it. He tipped it away.
So third down and 17. 3:19 to play. 21 all.
If we were going to give a player of the year, a player of the game, I'd give it to the whole secondary for Lexington.
Absolutely. That would be absolutely a good pick. So timeout on the field called, and it's called by Covington Catholic and Eddie Evanston. 3:19 to play, 21 all. This is the Mingy Beef Jerky High School Football Game of the Week, and, boy, it has been a good one here at Lexington Catholic, the end of regular season.
Yeah, thanks to Mingy Beef Jerky being the title sponsor for these games. I mean, it's a wonderful thing that all these sponsors do, letting these kids come out here and play. And, you know, they're trying to stay healthy and do the things they're supposed to do in the COVID time. And just really good football game tonight. You know what? Third and downtown here, I'm wondering if they don't just go ahead and quick kick this. And
no.
If Catholic doesn't put anybody back, that ball will roll forever, Gary.
Yeah, but I don't think they'll quit. I think they're going to – they'll go – they don't need to get 17. They can get maybe half of that here and go for it on fourth down because it's only 3 minutes to play, 3:19.
Yeah, but you don't want to give Lexington Catholic a good field position.
Yeah, it's true because they got a good kicker, Max DeGraff.
No kidding. You don't want to punt to him. You really – if you're going to punt toward the sideline, you don't want Woodall to carry that ball back.
Yeah, what Lexington Catholic's looking for is a pick – a fumble or a pick here, Coach. Looking for the – I mean, they've been playing great in the secondary.
Yeah.
Why not put this game away with another pick?
Yeah, know where the first down is. That's the key for defense. Know where that first down marker is. Don't let them get to the first down marker.
Triple receivers, Schneider, Reardon, Garrett Binky out to the top. Third and 17. Now shifting by Geiser, the freshman. Cameron Geiser comes out to the left side. Quarterback Jacob back to pass. Fires it down the middle, and it's going to be caught down to the 20-yard line by Schneider.
All right, we were talking about the quarterbacks. That's a good quarterback right there. That was a tremendous throw. We got a flag?
Yeah, there is a flag, I believe.
Way down the field, though, the flag was thrown. Who we got? Holding.
Holding against Lexington Catholic.
Decline, of course.
Yeah, that was a super catch by Schneider, and what a throw.
What a throw.
What a super. That's one of the best throws we've seen Cam Jacob make, even when we saw him play last year.
Yeah, that was an excellent throw. Let's take a look at what his stats are right now, Gary. He's 8 for 20, 101 yards.
So Jacob hasn't had a big night throwing, but he made a count on that one.
139 yards for Goman.
Yeah, and he's got three touchdown passes. Jack Goman does.
How important is this for both teams? Woo!
First down at the 20-yard line. Wide outs to both sides. And the Wilson goes in motion inside to Collins, and he's going to be tackled at about the 17-yard line. And Like Hall got him.
Yeah, Hall.
Robert Hall got him.
Yeah,
good play by Robert.
Yeah, he's a little shook up.
Yeah, he's
on
coming
this
out of there, yeah.
Yeah, he looked like he was favoring his shoulder or something, but I think he's all right. They pull him out. They just put a little quick some quicker people in there probably.
Yeah, well, they've also got big Quentin Duffy in there.
He's a big man.
6'1", 290 in their nose. Approaching 210 to play in this football game. Jacob sends Wilson back. That's shipped in the backfield. Side handoff.
Nice
bouncing
move.
Outside. And Collins down to the inside the 10-yard line with a minute 59 to play. Down to the 8. It's first and 10.
Yeah,
first and goal.
That was a pretty good move. Corbett on the tackle made a nice hard tackle there.
Braden Collins shifty on that, wasn't he, Coach?
Yeah, he was. He's a very, very quick runner. They're not going to take any chances here. They might try to center that ball and get that field goal for the win.
So Lexington Catholic and Covcath, a minute 40 to play, 21 all. First and goal at the 8-yard line for Cameron Jacob. Collins is to the left of him. Wilson goes in motion near us. Inside handoff to Collins, and he breaks a tackle at the 5, going down to about the 3-yard line. So first and it'll be second and goal from the 3.
Lexington Catholic needs to call a timeout here. Yeah, they did. That's good.
Timeout with a minute 20 to go. And yeah, we'll keep it here. Minute 20 to go, 21 all, Lexington Catholic and Covcath. Want to thank our producer tonight, Jack Haynes, and our videographer, and Ty Schott, and I think he's an Asbury guy.
All right, good for him.
Asbury, yeah. Well,
when's Asbury going to start football? He's shaking his head.
Minute 20, and it's 21 for Lexington Catholic, 21 for Covcath, but Covcath's on the march. They have second down, and second and goal at the 3-yard line. And this is where they like to bring in Nally, but I notice he's got a brace on his left leg, Coach.
Yeah, but he's a
load. He's got he's one pure, touchdown run already. So Covington Catholic trying to score here late in this game and pull this out. Minute 20 to go. 21-21. It was a classic last year. It's a classic tonight.
Again, exactly.
Another great game. Jacob. Nally's in there.
Quarterback sneak.
Long count. He's going to keep it, push forward, and he's going to get down near the goal line. And I think, is the official going to give it to him? They're running in from the side, and they're going to say his knee was –
They
gave it the touchdown, the side judge, from this left side.
They didn't know what to call. See that again, Jack. Can we look at that? Let's see if there's any question about that one. Well, heck, everybody's pushing them. You can't tell.
So 27-21, yeah. Covington Catholic, they were down 21-7. And now they've scored 20 unanswered, and it could be 21 unanswered right here if they kick this extra point. They got one of the best kickers in the state, Dave Granati.
So they brought Nally in to push.
To push.
To push the quarterback over the goal line.
Yeah, they're telling them to put more time on the clock. Yep. So Covcast scored. That's a sign that that's a good mark of a champion when you can – be down by 2 touchdowns, and all of a sudden, boom, 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 you're right back in it. Boom, you got the lead.
You got the lead. The Knights have played a really good game.
They really have. Granati's kick is up, and it is straight through, 28-21. Covington Catholic with a touchdown lead. They've erased a 21-7. Lexington Catholic lead with 1:10 to go in the ballgame. We'll be back on the Mingy Beef Jerky High School Football Game of the Week after this timeout.
Folks, this is Gary Ball, and you hear my catchphrase, soup and a sandwich. When I want the best potato soup and prime rib sandwich, I head over to Rafferty's Restaurants after my games. Check out Rafferty's 9 great locations throughout Kentucky, and all you teens, you can eat at Rafferty's before those big ball games. The open prime rib sandwich is what legends are made of. Ask Joe B. Hall, the legend himself, it's his favorite. Rafferty's a big supporter of high school sports throughout Kentucky. Rafferty's, where the special is you.
We're back. Joseph K. Ford Stadium. Gary Ball, great game. It's not over yet. A minute and 10 seconds. Who knows what can happen?
Woodall's broken two long runs here, but the kicker, Granati, got him twice and saved the touchdown. So maybe he can break another one here.
Yeah.
28-21. Covington Catholic has stormed back from a 21-7 deficit. They were trailing 21-7 in the third quarter, Coach. They've erased it with 21 unanswered.
2 years in a row.
Short kick and taken by the up guy to the 35. He's coming up near the 40, knocked backwards right there. And let's see, I believe that was Powell, wasn't it? Yeah, Powell, Jack Powell. Well, they've got good field position. Do they have any timeouts left, though? No, I don't think so. They don't have any timeouts up on the scoreboard. Is that correct?
It says they don't have any timeouts, but I thought I heard the announcer over there say that
they have one.
That they had one, but I don't know.
So here comes Jack Goman.
Boy, they're spreading the field here.
Yep. Of course, they had Bo Allen last year, and, boy, he worked a lot of magic, didn't he?
Yeah, he could throw the ball about 80 yards, too.
Yep. So triple receivers to the near side, twins to the top for Lex Cath. Here's a screen.
That's smart.
And it goes up to the 40-yard line.
Did you see how I make the tackle? Nally made the tackle.
Yep, and the player that caught it is shaking up a little bit. That's Blake Buesen.
Yeah, he might be hurt. That was. Look at his ankle. Coach Nigel Smith walking out to check on his player.
Yes, Buesen. 57 seconds to play. And
Nally came in there and hit him pretty hard.
Yep. One of the few times we've seen Nally in on defense, he's got the big brace on his left leg. He didn't run the ball much tonight.
No. No, he didn't.
So Covington Catholic and Lex Cath. And it was 21-7 in the third quarter. Lexington Catholic kind of coasting. And then I guess they poked a bear.
Yeah, they poked a bear is right. But pretty intense defensive battle by both teams. I know 28-21 sounds like a lot of scoring, but they had to work for everything they got.
Yep.
And penalties hurt both teams, too.
So they're helping Buesen up. Blake had two big touchdowns last year in the Covcath game up at Park Hills. Boy, what a beautiful stadium that is up there at Covcath and Park Hills.
It is.
You walk in the big – I mean, that place is impressive.
That's your neck of the woods.
Yeah, it's a lot better now than it was back when I did games there.
I bet.
57 seconds, 28-21. Let's see what Lexington Catholic has here. Second down. Here's Goman. Steps up. He's going to run with it. He's got some running room. Cuts it over the far side. He's to the 40, and he gets out of bounds at the 37. That's a great run there by Goman. He's picked up about 25 yards, Coach, and that's been there for him all night.
All night long. When they spread the field and run those receivers down, there's nobody on the quarterback, and he did a really smart job, too, running out of bounds there, Gary, and saving some time on that clock.
Yeah, we see the replay over there, Coach, and Goman got out of bounds at the 37-yard line. First down of Covcath. Goman back to pass. And he's going to roll it to the left side and throw it into the bench. Incomplete. 46 seconds to go in this ball game.
If he could have peeled back this way, we had a couple receivers open here on the right side, but, you know, he escaped out to the left side. There wasn't anybody open there.
So if Lexington Catholic trying to match Covcath with a big comeback here. They led 21-7. Covcath marched back, scored three unanswered touchdowns. They lead 28-21, 46 seconds, and it's second down at the 37 for Lexcath. Goman back in the pocket, fires it over the near side. He's got an open receiver. He's got the catch to the 20, and he's down to the inside the 20 in the red zone on the catch there made by Jack Mundy. Mundy's had a big catch and touchdown tonight and had another big catch there.
You know what I'm seeing, though? It's something that I love. I'm seeing leadership by Goman. That's one thing that in a quarterback that you want to look for, and I'm seeing it. I'm seeing he's calm, he's cool in the pocket.
Yeah. Yep. Triple receivers to the left. Goman back in the pocket. Goman looking, fires in the end zone. He's open. Mundy, he's got a touchdown in the corner of the end zone.
Do we go for two?
It's 28-27. No, I take my chances in overtime. I don't go for two. Do you, Coach?
I go for two.
You do?
Yeah, you're playing against the number one team in the state. You're playing against the number one team in the state. You've got the momentum going. I'd go for two.
So 28-27, touchdown pass to – that was Mundy, right?
Yeah.
Mundy wide open. It's like they don't want to cover Mundy tonight on a Friday.
What a nice pass, though. Really nice job, wasn't it? Just a nice job on the outside. They're going to –
So do you go for the win at home?
I'd go for the win at home. I mean, I know you never know if it's going to work or not, but you're playing against the number one team in the state. What the heck?
And Covcath, I think, gets their timeout.
Yeah, they wanted to see what they came out in.
Yeah, timeout by the Colonel. So we'll keep it right here.
Yeah.
28-27, 32 seconds to go. And the lead is for Covington Catholic, but Lexcat just threw a touchdown strike. That's the fourth touchdown pass tonight for Jack Goman.
Yeah, he's having a night. And like I said before, I'm watching him in the pocket. His feet are good. He's surveying the defense. When he gets in trouble, he's throwing the ball out of bounds. He's doing the smart things. Nice job. And like you said, Gary, that running has been open for him several times tonight where he could have run for a first down.
His 25-yard run on this drive was the play of the drive.
It was key. Absolutely.
That was the key. You're right. So he picked up that big first down to the 37. And Lexington Catholic, are they going for two here?
We'll see.
Two would possibly give them the win. There's still 32 seconds left, though. So
let me tell you something. If you go for two here and you get it as a coach, you've really gained the respect of your team.
Mundy's in there as a receiver to the right side. Out to the top is Woodall. Darren Eldridge is going to shift. He'll probably go out in the flats over there. Now motion, far side by Corbett. Goman's rolling that way, looking, throws it, and it's going to be. Is it caught? Yes, caught in the corner of the end zone. We can't see. There's too many people over there. Who caught that ball? Who caught that? Two-point conversion is good. Coach, take a look at the replay.
I think it was Corbett.
Just look at the replay.
It's Corbett, I think.
Okay. There's a replay. And you can tell us.
Yeah, Corbett.
Corbett with a two-point conversion.
Nice.
It's 29-28, Lexington Catholic. Leading number one ranked Covington Catholic.
32 seconds to go in the game. What a game, ladies and gentlemen.
You called it, Coach. You said they're going to go for two.
Yeah.
And they did.
Yeah. You see, you know, why not? You know, you're playing in a different division. You're playing the number one team in the state.
In 5A.
In 5A.
Apologies to Owensboro, who's 8-0. And apologies to Frederick Douglass, who's got a fine team. And apologies to South Warren.
I don't apologize to anybody.
Yeah, I'm just saying those are good teams also.
Yeah.
But this Covington Catholic team won the state championship last year, 15-0. And right now they're. I tell you what a comeback. And then what an answer by Goman.
Well, yeah, Goman's had a day. The whole team, the offensive line.
The secondary.
Right there in the secondary. It's a super job on defense. Both of these teams have really good defenses, Gary.
What do you do here on this kick? The ball falls off the tee, but do you kick it deep and take a chance that they return it, or what do you do here?
If you can kick it in the end zone, you do that. If you don't think you can, then you kick that ball hard on the ground, let it roll.
Cameron Geisler and Garrett Bink here back deep. 32 seconds, 29-28. Lexington Catholic. They just scored on a touchdown pass from Goman to Mundy and then got the two-point conversion. It's a deep kick, and it's going to be at the 5. It's going to be Binky. He's out to the 10. He's to the 20. Hit and tripped up at the 27-yard line, and a good play turned in there. And, Coach, that is Hall.
Powell, Jack Powell again. He's had a heck of a game.
Yeah. No, Coach, that was Pierce Hall.
Was it Hall?
Yeah,
number
Pierce
six?
Hall. Number 8.
Number 8.
It's hard
okay.
to see those numbers.
Yeah, it is. 6 and 8. You know.
Yeah. So at the 29-yard line, 27 seconds. So Lexington Catholic's got to keep them out of the end zone any way they can. And you'll have Reardon, 6'5", splits out to the near. Triple receivers to the bottom. Well, the quarterback, Jacob, he's back in the pocket. Looking. Fires over the middle, and it's caught by Reardon. He's going to break it down to the 40-yard line. Cuts it over the far side, and then finally run out of bounds by Woodall with 16 seconds to go.
Woodall has made some unbelievable plays tonight, too. The whole team, a whole Covington Catholic team ran down there. They're all excited to be down there. Now's the time to play some defense. I don't think either team has any timeouts left.
So 16 seconds, and they mark it back at the 28-yard line.
Well, he must have stepped out of bounds.
Yeah, must have stepped out of bounds.
Yeah.
But what a catch by Reardon. We've been talking about him all night, haven't we, Coach?
Yeah.
He's 6'5".
Who's in the backfield with the
quarterback's got Braden Collins to his right.
Collins.
At the 28-yard line, Cam Jacob looking, rolling to the right, and he's going to tuck it and needs to tackle him in bounds. He's still in bounds, and they're still running the clock.
Well, I saw a flag, though.
Okay.
We might have had a face mask penalty.
Wasik tackled him.
Oh, they called a timeout right away.
Timeout by Covcath with 7 seconds to go in this football game, 29-28. Lexington Catholic just scored with 32 seconds to go, and they hit Mundy for a touchdown in the corner of the end zone. They went for two. They got it to Corbett from Goman, and there that 7 seconds to go in this game. Only got time for maybe throw one to the end zone maybe once.
Yeah.
I don't know about twice.
No, they can't. They have time to throw a quick out to get closer, but why do that? The quarterback's got plenty of arm. You know, they tried a little out and up pattern on that. And, I mean, there are so many things that they're trying to do against this secondary. But I'm telling you what, Lexington Catholic secondary's played.
You know who got Lexington Catholic ready for this game? And I know Lexington Catholic's not going to like this, but I don't care. Boyle County.
Boyle County did.
They got them ready for this game with that vaunted offense and defense. And Lex Catholic's like a different team tonight than they did it in Boyle County game, don't they?
Yeah, they do.
Their secondary's played outstanding. Well, we're going to have a long field goal here, and they're going to place it down at the, 35. It'll be a 46-yarder. This kid can make them from there, Coach. And we're going to have a timeout.
That must be the last timeout.
Try to ice him. Timeout for Lex Cath. So it will be about a 46, 47-yarder here for Dave Granati going to Army. You mentioned what a tough kid he is.
He's really tough. You've seen him making tackles out there. Usually the kicker, you know, it's, oh, well, that's a kicker. I can run past him. Granati's been, like, ripping them, making tackles. Well, we knew it would be a good one.
Yeah.
But it's a great
one. This is a classic.
It is a great football game.
Yeah, 29-28, Lexington Catholic. And we're going to have a long field goal here. I'm surprised they didn't go at least run one more play, but I guess they thought, well, you know, if we don't get out of bounds, that's going to run the clock out.
Yeah.
And you don't doubt Eddie Evanston.
Yeah, it would have to be run a quick out if you immediately when the quarterback gets the ball, if you can throw it fine, if not, throw it out of bounds. That's the last-ditch effort. So,
7 seconds, and Granati, they're going to place it down at the 36. It'll be a 46-yarder on the far hash mark with 7 seconds. Granati waiting for the placement. Placement down. It's blocked! Lexington Catholic blocks it. And time is going to run out. Lexington Catholic wins the ball game. Lexington Catholic pulls off the huge upset over number one ranked Covcath, 29-28, and we'll get a replay on that, Coach. You can tell us who blocked it. What a block.
Well, I hope you zoomed in on this. I don't see who blocked it. I couldn't tell.
What a game. That is the signature win for Nigel Smith, 29-28.
Unbelievable.
Lexington Catholic
game.
Knocks off Covington Catholic here tonight. That'll be Covington Catholic's only loss, and they'll probably drop them out of the number one ranking, Owensboro or Douglas or South Warren will be probably number one. We'll see when those rankings come out. Coach?
I'm going to see if I can find out who blocked
okay,
that.
Okay, Coach, we just witnessed. Let's take a break. Let's take a break. 29-28. Jack's doing some stuff on replays. And Coach is trying to find out who blocked the kick. So 29-28. We'll tell you this. It was 14-7 Covcath at half. Then they led 21-7 on a touchdown pass to Mundy. And then with 32 seconds, he threw to Mundy again in the corner. And then the two-point conversion, and Lexington Catholic pulls it out 29-28.
They still can't – they can't figure out who blocked it.
I know. We're trying to – looking at the replay to – So 29-28.
There's no way you can tell who blocked it, Jack.
Nope.
Because it's such a long field goal, the camera was pretty far back on it. So.
Yeah, he had to do that to get the whole field goal. It was a 46-yard attempt. It was blocked by Lex Kath. And, hey, Jack, let's step out, come back, and then we'll give some final stats and wrap it up here. 29-28, Lexington Catholic over Covington Catholic.
Same apples, same phone, same coffee, same items, different prices. So why would you pay more for the same thing? Lexington Diagnostic Center and Open MRI can save you 30 to 60% compared to the costs of local hospitals. We have a state-of-the-art facility in the Lexington area. We believe that every patient deserves the best in affordable, quality care. Avoid surprise billing. Come to Lexington Diagnostic Center, imaging focused on you.
By the numbers, Whitaker Bank loves the Kentucky communities we serve.
Whitaker Bank supports 496 Kentucky schools.
Over 282,000 students benefit from Whitaker Bank's Kentucky education initiatives.
Whitaker Bank has contributed almost $441,000 to education programs for the advancement of Kentucky's youth.
We share your passion, Kentucky.
Love the bank that loves you back.
Whitaker Bank is uniquely Kentucky.
Same shoes, same mixer, same computer, same items, different prices. So why would you pay more for the same thing? Lexington Diagnostic Center and Open MRI can save you 30 to 60% compared to the costs of local hospitals. We have a state-of-the-art facility in the Lexington area. We believe that every patient deserves the best in affordable, quality care. Avoid surprise billing. Come to Lexington Diagnostic Center, imaging focused on you.
Folks, this is Gary Ball, and you hear my catchphrase, soup and a sandwich. When I want the best potato soup and prime rib sandwich, I head over to Rafferty's Restaurants after my games. Check out Rafferty's 9 great locations throughout Kentucky, and all you teens, you can eat at Rafferty's before those big ball games. The open prime rib sandwich is what legends are made of. Ask Joe B. Hall, the legend himself, it's his favorite. Rafferty's a big supporter of high school sports throughout Kentucky. Rafferty's, where the special is you.
Welcome back. Here we are at Lexington Catholic High School. Big game. What a finish. Blocked field goal right at the end with no time on the clock. Super job by Lexington Catholic. A signature win, as Gary Ball says, for Lexington Catholic in this COVID-ridden season. Nice job by both teams, Gary. I'm going to go over some team stats for you. First down, 17 for Covington Catholic, 13 for Lexington Catholic. Rushing yards, 43 rushes, 170 yards for Covington Catholic, 92 yards for Lexington Catholic. Covington Catholic did run the ball really well tonight and didn't use Nally very much, who was the number one runner coming in.
Yeah, he had an injury of some kind on his left knee. He had a brace on it, so I don't know what the injury was, but I'm not speculating. But he did not play much in this game. He made a good defensive play there late in the game, though.
Yes, he did. 180 yards passing for Lexington Catholic, 140 yards, 44 yards passing for Covington Catholic. Passes 21 passes, 9 completion for Covington Catholic. 27 times Goldman threw the ball, 16 completions. A really good job.
4 touchdowns.
Yeah, 4 touchdowns. I'm going to jump down here real quick because looking at penalties. Penalties, 3 penalties for 32 yards for Covington Catholic and 2 penalties. Really clean game from both teams,
yeah,
Gary.
Yeah, really good.
Very clean game from both teams. Let's see. 3rd down conversion, 7 for 13 for Covington Catholic and 4 for 6. 4 for Lexington Catholic. So here's some individual stats.
Okay, and looking at individually, Coach already gave the passing. Receiving, Reardon had 3 catches, 64 yards, 2 catches for 51 yards for Schneider. Wilson had 1 catch for 15 yards. Blake Buesen had 5 catches for 34 yards and a touchdown. 4 for Mundy, 39 yards. Mundy had 2 big touchdown catches. Cord had 4 catches, 51 yards, and a touchdown. And Chase Blair had 3 catches for 6 yards. Looking at individually, looking at tackles, Powell had 8 tackles. Total, Corbett had 6. Pierce Hall had 5.5. Woodall had 5. Aiden Jones led just 4.5 tackles for, and Dickhouse had 4.5 for CovCav. Looking at the scoring, let's look at time of possession, though, before I get to the score.
Yeah, that's interesting.
Time of possession, you had 31 minutes and 9 seconds because they had the ball for about 12 minutes on the one drive they scored.
I know.
So 31 minutes, 9 seconds. Just six. They doubled up the time on the LexCath, but Lexington Catholic won the game 29-28. Let's look at the scoring. It started in the first half, 7:19 mark. CovCath scored. Caleb Jacob, 1 yard. He was pushed into the end zone. Dave Granati's kick made it 7-0. And then with 3 minutes 10 seconds to go, Lexington Catholic came back. Blake Buesen hauled in a 4-yard TD pass. He was wide open in the corner of the end zone over there, Coach.
It was.
And Jack Goman found him for the touchdown. DeGraff's kick made it 7-all. And then with 12 seconds to go before halftime, Jackson Corbett hauled in a 32-yard pass from Goman, and DeGraff's kick made it 14-7 at halftime. It was a Lexington Catholic lead. Then Lexington Catholic came out, got the ball. They went down. Jack Mundy hauled in a 46-yard TD pass from Goman, and then DeGraff's kick made it 21-7, Lexington Catholic by 14 points. Well, as we said from last year, it ain't over till it's over. With 8:48 to go in the ball game, Nally went in 3 yards out. Granati's kick made it 21-14. 5:42 to go. Back came CovCath again. Aiden Jones with the fumble recovery in the end zone after the quarterback was running. Then the ball was knocked out. Who did we discover that was knocked out by? The quarterback fumble in the end zone. It doesn't matter. Aiden Jones recovered it for the score, and it was 21-all. And then with 1:06 to go in the game, a CovCath, Caleb Jacob went 3 yards out for the score. Granati's kick made it 28-21, but hold the phone, as they say. Hold the phone. 32 seconds in the ball game. Back came Lexington Catholic. Jack Mundy hauled in a 20-yard TD pass in the corner, wide open from Jack Goman, and Corbett got the two-point. They went for two, like you predicted, Coach, and Corbett hauled in the two-point conversion, 29-28. That's how it ends. What a ball game here at Lexington Catholic, and what a way for Lexington Catholic to go into the playoffs,
right,
huh, Coach?
What momentum, the whole bit going. Yeah, they're strong. And who knows, they may get a bye in the first round of the playoffs.
That's exactly right. They might get a bye. We're not sure what's going on with Bourbon County. who's in their district. We think they've called off football because of COVID. But anyway, great job, Jack Haynes, Ty Shad. Great job, guys, tonight producing here on Prep Spin for the king of stream, William Warfield, who was over. He had some other duties, some other obligations.
He missed a good one.
Yeah, he missed the best game of I don't know. The game last year, Covington Catholic, was pretty good. I think this might have been better.
It was a lot more fun. It was just really fun.
Yeah,
because
the right team won.
Yeah,
Lexington Catholic. That's who we cover. So Lexington Catholic wins it 29-28, and they blocked a field goal in the last seconds. Eric Granati had it teed up, and I tell you what, he got a lot of leg into that one.
He did. He did.
Yeah. So Lexington Catholic wins it 29-28 over the number one ranked team in 5A Covcast. So there'll be a new number one team come Monday when Dave Cantrell's rankings come out in the Herald Leader. So there'll be a new number one team in 5A anyway. I think it'll be Owensboro. I think Owensboro's 8-0 or something like that. They have that big 6'4 quarterback back that's just a stud. So I think it'll be Owensboro. It could be Douglas, but I think it'd be Owensboro.
I do too, because Douglas, I think, they didn't play a couple games, correct?
Yeah, they've only played four games, and they had another game they only played a quarter and then started lightning on them. So
Right. They've
really only played four games, and that's really a big disadvantage for them. Lexcath, with the win tonight, they go to 5-2 on the season, but look at their schedule.
Right.
I mean, they played number one in the state Covcath. They played number one in the state Boyle County. Apologies to Johnson Central, and they played number one in the state Lexington Christian. Yeah, so they played a really brutal schedule.
Pretty good schedule.
Yeah. So Lexington Catholic 5-2 now.
But you know, you said something really prophetic, and I thought, you know, when you said that Boyle County prepared Lexington Catholic for a game like this.
There's no doubt about it. Absolutely. You find out against a team like Boyle County what all you need to improve on.
Yep.
Well, they knew they needed to improve on in the secondary because Jaggers just picked them apart. So they came out here tonight and they played real good in the secondary.
Lights out in the secondary.
That's why Lexington Catholic won this game. Their secondary was stellar tonight. And just look at the numbers. How do we back that up? You look at a great quarterback like Caleb Jacob. He was 9 of 21 tonight. 9 of 21 and two interceptions.
And a couple knocked down, too. Right. Passes knocked away from the receiver.
So Lexington Catholic wins at 29-28. They blocked the field goal by Granati from 46 yards out with no time remaining on the clock. And so they win the game. So Lexington Catholic wins it 29-28. For my broadcast teammates tonight, we had a great crew tonight, Jack Haynes and Ty Shad. And for Coach Mike Meehan, join us next week for all the playoffs around Kentucky. We have playoff action here on the Prep Spin. We know Sayre is at Pikeville, the number one team. That's a top 10 battle. Sayre's at Pikeville, number one and number seven in the state. Sayre's still undefeated on the season. They'll play next Friday night. We know that's one of the games that we're looking at here on Prep Spin. Again, for the Mingy Beef Jerky High School Football Game of the Week, this is Gary Ball. Lexington Catholic stuns Covington Catholic. 29-28, the final. So long.